Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the field the Brisbane Lions.
Test 1-2-2-2. Test 1-2.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Brisbane Lions, coached by Nathan Clark, their team in number order. 1, Sam Doherty, 5, Billy Longa, 12, James Hawksley, 13, Callum Bartlett, 17, Clay Beans, 19, Jordan Lowell, 26, Elliot Yeo, 27, Josh Dyson, 28, Patrick Carnesis, 32, Shaney Stiller, 33, Amon Buchanan, 37, Patrick Weirden, 40, Niall Makeda, 42, Justin Clark, 44, Aaron Cornelius, 46, Sam Michael, 47, Jack Crisp, 48, Stephen Wrigley, 52, Scott Clark, 54, Jack Fox, 58, Dave Cummings, 64, Jesse Wallen, and 65, Isaac Conway. Coach by Nathan Clark, the Brisbane Lions, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you.
And ladies and gentlemen, their opponents today in the NEAFL Northern Grand Final, the current premiers from 2011, the NT Thunder. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, we'd firstly like to acknowledge the traditional owners of this land where we meet here today and acknowledge our Indigenous elders, past and present. Before we now go to the national anthem, firstly, ladies and gentlemen, last week in Las Vegas, the AFL lost one of their own in the tragic passing of Port Adelaide youngster John McCarthy. Can we just have a minute silence for John McCarthy? Thank you. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Our thoughts are with his family. I'd now like to introduce a special guest to sing the Australian National Anthem, Miss Yasmin Raja, Principal of Grace Note Studios Performance Academy, award-winning jazz vocalist, and currently starring in the Natalie Cole Show and Ebony and Ivory Burlesque Show. Let's make her welcome to sing the National Anthem. Please be upstanding, Yasmin Raja.
3, 2, 1, 4. Thank you. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Leyshon Park in Yeronga for the NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final for season 2012. The Brisbane Lions taking on the NT Thunder. Perfect day for football here in Brisbane today. 22 degrees, little bit of cloud cover, absolute comfort for the players to go around in. It's a pleasure bringing you the game today for Thunder Vision. Sean Kelly's my name. Joining me to call the game today, one of the true doyens of football in the Queensland media. A very good afternoon to Ron McDonald.
Yeah, thanks very much for that very fine introduction, Sean. Yeah, like you say, beautiful day here in Brisbane, perfect temperature around about 22, 23 degrees, slight breeze blowing. We saw in the reserves that the breeze made, the scoring end was the southern end.
To the right of screen for those playing along at home.
Yes, for those of you, and we do have a fairly big viewing audience today by the look, Sean. We've got all those people up there at Kazali's, Palmerston in the NT, who will be following the Thunder's progress with great interest. We're also streaming through the NEAFL website, the Lions website, and Thunder Vision. So hopefully we get ourselves a contest worthy of the occasion of a grand final. Very different circumstances to 12 years ago, to a year ago, 12 months ago, when the Thunder played in their very first grand final and dealt out the biggest, they produced both the biggest score in QAFL NEAFL history and also the greatest winning margin of 16 goals against Morningside. But they'll go in this time, they'll go in as the underdogs against a Brisbane Lions reserves team that looks very, very strong on paper. They were terrific 7-goal winners in the second semi-final up in there in Darwin, broke a 24-game winning streak for the Thunder in Darwin. So the Thunder boys have got their work ahead of them. How do you see the game panning out?
They certainly do. It's going to be a very interesting game. The Thunder last week controlled the game early against Southport. Southport came back into it in the end, and then they did enough to basically get their way into the grand final. One change to the side from last week, Jake Dignan back into the side. He didn't play, of course, last week with the birth of his son Harrison last Sunday on game day. The game was on Saturday last week. Harrison was born on Sunday, so Jake's back into the side, replacing Nathan Brown, who goes out for the grand final.
And Dignan, as those close followers of the Thunder will remember, won the Joe Grant medal for the best player on the ground in the grand final last year, enjoyed a tremendous final series. He's a very big in. If the Thunder are going to win this football game, they need all their best players playing. Cameron Islett really stood up last week in the clinch to win the game there against Southport. It will need Cameron Islett to star. It will need Jake Dignan to play well. It'll need goals from the big fella Buff Ewing there at full forward. Every one of their good players is going to have to play well.
It'll be interesting to see also Austin Wanamiri and Shannon Rusk, two players with AFL experience, two of the most decorated Territorian players there are, both back into the side in the last couple of weeks, both flashed in and out last week. They'll be better for the run. Probably expect big things. I reckon Shannon Rusker's link and work across halfback is going to be crucial today.
Well, the Thunder are on back-to-back travels. They've been good starters, Sean. They've won their last 10 first quarters, whereas the Lions have lost 4 of their last 5 first quarters. So the Thunder are going to want to get out of the blocks again quickly, get themselves a handy lead, and they are kicking to what we believe will be the scoring end of the ground.
Kicking to the right of screen in the first quarter, the NT Thunder. Darren Ewing's taken his spot in the goal square. Ball's raised high in the air. It's time to start the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final. And there's the first bounce. Favours Tyrrell, but Longer comes in and gets the tap down. Tried to get it to Beams. Couldn't quite take it with him. Pack forms over the footy. And are we going to have a secondary stoppage? No, it's going to be a free kick going the way of the Lions, I believe, Ronnie.
Yeah, Billy Longer's won himself the free kick. There was a good second effort there. He won the tap and then he followed it up at ground level. So he's going to put the Lions into attack. That's the first forward 50 entry of the game. There's Jason Wright. Big fly from Cornelius at the back. Went too early. That was Rusker. Gets an early touch. That'll do his confidence the word of good. Vassell got his hands on the ball. The run's coming off half back there, but the handball's missed the mark. It was Matty Argus in his 100th senior game of football. Ball's gone down there forward looking for Ewing. Couldn't quite get the ball. Bounces back out there towards the Lions. Are wrapped up there at half forward. Umpire's going to give ourselves a ball up. Ewing, I've seen him take some of those one-handers in the past there, Sean.
Justin Clark's got the job on him today. Looks like he was wearing Ewing pretty close as the ball went into the forward line as well.
And very interesting matchup there. It looks like Eamon Buchanan is going to pay close attention there to Cameron Islett. Very interesting that in the Lions' 2 wins this year over the Thunder, that Cameron Islett has had his influence nullified, and I think that'll probably be one of the keys for the Lions today is to shut him out of the game as Clay Beams comes out of defence. They're looking for Jordan Lyle. Good fist there by Jason Rowe, and we've got ourselves a throw in right in front of the old Yeronga clubhouse that has been rebuilt, albeit in a much smaller version. Incredible to think that that less than 2 years ago, this ground was about 5 foot underwater from the Great Brisbane floods.
So the ball thrown back in. Longa gets front position. Two-hand tap. Anderson couldn't take. In fact, it was Vassal, couldn't take it away for the Thunder. Carnezis laid the tackle for the Lions. It's going nowhere, though. We're going to have another ball up about 50 metres out from the Thunder goal. So no score yet. Almost 2 minutes into the game. Ball's bounced. Longa and Tyrrell. Longa again. Rosier takes it from the stoppage. Team of the year representative for the Thunder and came second in the Grogan medal. Feeds out to Ruska. Bombs long from 50. Pack forms. Good work, Thunder. Bring the ball to ground, but no one's home. And the ball goes over the boundary line for a boundary throw in right next to the Lions' goal.
Looks like Vassal's got the job up against Clay Beams. Beams, NAB Rising Star nomination from the very first round of the season. As it's Longa up against Lockwood this time. Lockwood wins the tap, but it's put straight into the path of the Lions. There, that's Cummins flicks the ball over, looking for Weirden, but the boundary Lions are going to beat them. So we're playing the first ever grand final at Yeronga here, not far from the city of Brisbane. As you see from the goes to the northern end, we'll see the city in the background. Last year it was out in Bayside Redlands, where the Thunder certainly produced a magnificent second half to overrun Morningside. As we've got ourselves another ball up, Sean, looks like we might see a lot of these ball ups played in tight because there's not a man inside the Lions attacking our side of the ground as we speak.
Yep, Lions playing the full ground press. Southport did it last week against the Thunder as well, as Vassal took the loose ball but ran straight into a tackle. Ball still going nowhere, just inside 50 for the Thunder. Now the Lions kick across goal, but it's on. They've got players on. The bounce of the football's not kind, though. Goes over the boundary line, beats Sam Doherty, and it'll go over for a boundary throw-in.
Well, there is a bit of a cross breeze blowing here, Sean. It seems to have, was fluky earlier on in the day, but it certainly does seem to be favouring this side of the ground now, and the way that ball bent would indicate that.
So the ball thrown back in. Lockwood got the tap over the back. Beams tried to take it off the pack, couldn't do so. Rosier puts himself over the footy. Longa just muscles the football off Rosier and tried to get out of the pack, couldn't do so. We're going to have another ball up. So you always find these first couple of minutes of any grand final, be it whatever level, is always just a feeling out kind of nervous period where a lot of stoppages and both teams really just feeling their way. As third man up that time was Anderson that got the tap for the Thunder. Lions trying to bring it out, and again there's 12 players around the footy, and the ruck and maul sees it over the boundary line for a boundary throw in front of the spiffy new AFL Queensland headquarters here at Yeronga.
Well, this start will probably suit the Lions just as both teams are feeling their way out. We've crossed the 4 minute mark of this opening term, no score as yet. Longa up against Lockwood, the centre half forward for the Thunder. That was Beams, read it beautifully off the pack. Ball comes down there towards the middle, that eluded Bartlett. Good handball there, this is Tap. Played at centre half back, one of the keys in the grand final win last year. Gave it to Islet. That's a long kick on the left foot. Farrah flew high, couldn't quite take it. We remember some of the spectacular marks he took last year. Ball spills to Lockwood. He's got Farrah running for him, doesn't sit. Lions are back there in numbers, and again they're going to relieve there through Cummins. He gives it to Doherty. Doherty's got the men on the outside. They've got the switch working well. That was the Irishman McIver. He's given it to Wrigley. He'll run. Looks downfield, he's got a man loose on the wing. That's Fox, the young Western Magpies top-up player in his second season with the Brisbane Lions reserves. He dishes off to James Hawksley. Hawksley's got Cheney still running for him.
The skipper today.
Stiller's played a lot of senior football, had a man open downfield, but eludes him and the ball bounces out of bounds for a throw-in in the forward pocket.
Yeah, Cheney Stiller, the captain of the Lions today. It's been James Hawksley for most of the NEAFL season. However, he's elevated to the seniors late into the year and Cheney Stiller took over the reins as captaincy.
So the first chance for the Lions forwards to see a bit of the football. Aaron Cornelius has been particularly dangerous out of the goal scare all season. He's averaged almost 5 goals a game. He's kicked 53 for the winter. As we saw there, he had a big leap at the football there earlier, and he's capable of taking the big hang. That's him there. Wins the knot, but it's Matty Argus in his 100th game. Takes the football, but he's locked up there, and it looks like we'll get ourselves another bounce. Very good servant for the NT Thunder since he went up there from Windsor-Zilmere. Was actually played in the 2006 grand final for Windsor-Zilmere. It was a memorable game. They were overrun by Southport in the last quarter. He's played some very good football off a wing for the Thunder. again, there's a lot of players around the ball. It's going to be tough to get that football out. Runs onto it, does Beams. He's been busy early. Oh, Rowe takes the football, charges around three of them. He's a good footballer, Jason Rowe, as we saw when he used to play for the Lions. This is long. Lockwood crashes the pack, puts the pressure on, butters up again. It's one against two, and then we're going to get ourselves another throw in on the boundary.
No surprise to see Jason Rowe named as the fullback in the team of the year for the NEAFL during the week. Seven team of the year representatives playing today, as well as Jason Rowe. Jake Dignan from the Thunder named in the centre, Darren Ewing at full forward, and Matthew Rosier on the interchange. And for the Lions, Stephen Wrigley was named in a back pocket, Shaney Stiller and James Hawksley on the wings.
Well, Argus won the ball there down towards half forward, but it's chopped off by Dockett. He goes long, looking for Cornelius, couldn't hang on to it. Bartlett goes in there, he can't grab it. This is Rowe again, who's looked good early. He looks for Rosier, the Centralian. Boy from Alice Springs, he's played in his 50th game today. Oh, no free kick. Tap mops up, fortunately, for the Thunder. Gives it to Ruska. He comes out, no man in particular on the wing. He'd be looking for the ball to go out.
Just kicking it to
us. Lions look for a free kick, not forthcoming. We're going to get a throw in right in front of the commentary position. Reasonable crowd on this side of the ground, Sean. We might be stretching up 1,500, 2,000 people here. As the ball gets thrown in, it's Tyrrell against Longa. Tyrrell took front position. Longa falls onto the football. Umpire Baldwin, 38 years of age in his sixth grand final. Terrific effort by Jason Baldwin. Very, very composed and controlled umpire. So we've got to bounce up. We've played 7 minutes, almost 8 minutes into this first quarter. There's still no score. Longa took first position this time. Got the ball down, but to no one in particular. Dunn, the Thunder's second leading goal scorer on. He, having started the game on the interchange bench. Interesting move by the Lions too, Sean. Sam Michael, who I'd suggest has been their best player through their opening two games, started on the interchange bench.
Yeah, they'll hopefully bring him into the game. When I think they're thinking, wait until the heat's come out of the game a little bit, although it's definitely on as Islett put his head over the football and went in hard. Got nowhere. And umpire Baldwin calls for the football once again. Lions ring the changes, introduce Scott Clark into the fray. He's going to go straight into this contest, and Kendrick Tyrrell just greets him with a bit of an elbow as well. As there's the bounce, Tyrrell against Clark. Tyrrell gets the fist towards forward 50. Good tackling that time. In fact, that's probably holding the ball. Umpire says yes, it is. Great tackle by Jack Lawler that time. He can put the Thunder inside forward 50. Goes for the pass and finds Ewing on the lead. So Puff Ewing, a chance for his first goal of the day. Kicked the first goal of the preliminary final last week, which ended up being his only goal for the day. But this will bring the Thunder crowd to their feet if he can slot through the first one of the grand final.
Great work there by Jack Lawler. Terrific tackle. He's actually a Darwin boy who spent time growing up in Cairns and the islands north of there and played in a premiership with Morningside. He'd love to be a dual premiership player as Ewing has broken the duck. We've just crossed the 9 minute mark of the first quarter, and Darren Ewing kicks his 67th goal of the season and his 341st career goal to give the Thunder the first score of the game. They're 1-6. They lead the Lions reserves, who are yet to score. And Sean, it was always going to take some sort of a tackle or something like that to break open this game.
Yeah, it's exactly what happened, Jack Lawler, and a beautiful kick too. Just put it into the space for Ewing to lead into. And when you give the big fella that much room, he doesn't drop them, and made no mistake from 48 metres out.
Well, big job for young Sam Doherty playing on Austin Wanamiri there in the back pocket. That'll be an interesting duel, and Wanamiri looks like he's dropped a ton of weight as the season's gone on. Cameron Islett, he's got his hands on the ball several times in heavy traffic, and he does so again as Ruska pumps the ball forward. Doherty took front position against Wanamiri on that occasion. Stiller won the hard ball, chips it upfield, but they've coughed it up again. Tacked the ball there to the Thunder. Dunn tries to put the tackle on, but Stiller evades it nicely, goes onto the right foot, doesn't get a lot of distance. That was Karnesis, couldn't get a handle on it, but the run's fallen there for Doherty again, who's followed the ball well downfield, but the handball's missed the mark, and we get ourselves another throw in on the centre wing.
Football went through the interchange that time as well, and so did Cameron Islett. He's come off for a rest. Jed Anderson's onto the ground for the Thunder. The football on centre wing, commentary side of the ground. Back the pack, Vern comes on now, gets the tap down. Thunder tried to take it away over the football that time was Lawler. Lions crack in, well done. Move it out onto the wing, and Crisp. Crisp kicks inside forward 50. Well played by Tapp. Gets a fist to it and finds the boundary line as well. Beautiful work by Sean Tapp as the ball goes over for a throw in about 55 around from the Lions' goal.
Well, Jordan Lyle played some impressive football for the Lions seniors over the last three or four weeks of the season, but Sean Tapp certainly had a couple of good wins in one-on-one situations there. Great battle. Tapp was considered a possibility as a draft prospect early in his career. As a 19-year-old, he played state football, and we'll just see how good he is today against a class player in Lyle. That was Bartlett's dished out the clever handball to Stiller. He looks downfield, takes a good composed mark. Balance, but that was Rusker who intercepted for
the
Thunder. He's
been busy early, Shannon Rusker.
Looked particularly good as he kicks long downfield looking for Lockwood. Big fly from the back by that man, Farrah. Weirden gets the handball off the pack. This is Yeo, who was impressive in several senior games for the Lions, but a great intercept by Ben Rioli, who's been terrific for the Thunder in defence. Ewing's taken front position, got rid of his opponent, got rid of young Crisp. That's a one-on-one that the Thunder certainly wanted, and now Ewing will line up for his second as we cross the 11.5-minute mark of this opening term of the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final.
Always risky by Elliot Yeo, kicking into the centre of the ground to a flat-footed player. Then it was well done by Rioli to pick it off, and then just Ewing able to wrong-foot his opponent. His left foot kicks on its way. He's kicked his second goal, Darren Ewing, for the game. Thunder have got the only two so far. 12-minute mark of this opening quarter. Thunder are two straight 12. Brisbane Lions are yet to score. It's the Darren Ewing show at Leyshon Park in Yeronga so far, Ronnie.
Well, Ewing was left one out there against Crisp, and the light-bodied Crisp is going to struggle every time if he's up against a bulky player like...
He wrong-footed like him as well.
Wrong-footed him beautifully. He used his bulk to perfection. And that's what they want, the Thunder, if they can create those one-on-ones for Ewing. He's going to cause all sorts of problems, as we've seen so far. It's just, that's the youngster Justin Clark going back to him now, who's obviously got probably...
He was his opening matchup as well.
Yeah, look, I think he got caught up in the play there, and... left back there as Vincombe goes up and wins the tap. Lions have sharked it out of the middle, but Rowe, who's played in front on every occasion the ball's gone down there, holds his feet almost. Run to the advantage of Rioli now. He looks downfield, chips it in towards Lockwood. McKeever gets his fist to it. Stiller's waiting at ground level. He judges it better. McKeever's going to butter up. He's got men across half-back if he wants them. Uses Yeo. This is Wrigley. Made his senior debut in Perth against the West Coast Eagles. Kicks it beautifully across their weighted kick, and he finds Doherty, who has been busy, and he looks like he's been given the task of just running off Wanamiri on every occasion. Callum Bartlett, he's a very classy left foot, a high draft pick who's had his share of knee problems. He's looked better as the season's gone on. That was Yeo, who's dished it off again. Bartlett steps around, looks inboard, but he's looking for Doherty, but it's chipped in by Argus, who's been busy early. Looking for Farrah, goes down towards Ewing, or just evaded the Farrah running in towards goal. It's going to be mopped up there again by Wrigley. Ball calls the crowd. This is Rosier. He's on the left foot, but he can't get any clear space. Wanamiri gets his first touch. Butters up again, but it's only gone to his direct opponent, Doherty. Doherty's also been busy, giving it to Cornesis. This is Chris, back to Cornesis. He's got a man on down in the wing. That's Hawksley. It's overshot him. Nice bounce there. Looks like Michael, who's on for a run. This is Buchanan. They've got the run here. They've got two of them, three of them running downfield. This is Weirden on the left foot. No, it's not Weirden. It's Crisp. Crisp, he's made no mistake, and the Lions are on the board. It's taken 14 minutes and 3 seconds, but the Brisbane Lions have got the first goal, and they've shown just what they do. They run and hunt in numbers there. They've swept the ball beautifully from deep in defence without the Thunder touching the ball. And they had two or three men unmarked there running in towards the open goal, and Crisp made no mistake from 45 metres, and that'll do their confidence some good.
So the Lions on the board with their first. They trail at 1-6-2, 12 for the Thunder. 14.5 minutes into this opening quarter. And beautiful work by you there, Ronnie, as well. I didn't hear a breath in all that, and you nailed every piece of play beautifully. So the ball back into the centre of Leyshon Park here in Yeronga. Poe wastes no time bouncing it. Tyrrell back into the ruck against Longer again. Islet off the back of the square can go inside forward 50. Lions had the men but just couldn't quite control the footy. Now Doherty's got a battle at ground level. Umpire's going to call for another stoppage. We'll have the ball up 45 out from the Thunder goal.
And Cameron Islet's made two centre clearances and looking very dangerous in there. He's certainly on today, and that's really, really important factor for the Thunder.
Ball bounced. Good work at front spot by Tyrrell. Lions get the ball at ground level, though. Just couldn't quite take it away from the stoppage. A lot of players around the football at the moment, resembling probably more of a rugby ruck and maul than an AFL game in this set at the moment. Football's going nowhere. An umpire again calls for it. We'll have another ball up in almost exactly the same spot as what we just did.
Yeah, like you called it, Sean, there's an awful lot of players around the football.
It's almost like under-16s footy.
Just determined not to let any easy kicks there for the Thunder, as that was Lockwood up against Longer. Again, there's a pack of players around the football. It's going to be very difficult to get this ball out, and the umpire's going to have to call it up and ball it up again at half forward for the Thunder. They lead 2 goals, 12 to 1 goal, 6. We've approached the 15-minute mark and crossed it of this first quarter of the NEAFL Grant Northern Conference Grand Final. Longer against Lockwood. Longer wins the tap. Karnesis has been getting his hands on the ball, but hasn't been particularly effective as yet. That was Fox off the left. Good spoil there from behind by the Thunder. But tap ahead. Looks like crisp again. No, it's Fox looking downfield towards Lyle. Again, good spoil by Tap. Tap crushes through. That's strong football by Sean Tap. Good work in getting his left foot to the ball. This is Duncan. Was looking for Argus. Overshot him, but Rosie is in there to help. Spins out of the tackle. Trips as the umpire. And Matty Rosier, the boy from Alice Springs. He wastes no time in wheeling around on the trusty left foot. There's plenty of carry on that football. Oh, Farrar good was night. Taken out off the football. No free kick, says the umpire. Farrar appeals for it, but it's not forthcoming. It's chipped across there towards Yeo.
So Elliot Yeo for the Brisbane Lions. He's going to come back from whence it came. Finds Justin Clark. Clark switches out towards the commentary side, towards Doherty. Doherty marks on defensive 50. Finds Clay Beams with the next option. Clay Beams, the walking billboard, finds a teammate in Cummins. Takes a bounce down the wing, needs to change direction. Rosier slips over at the crucial moment, so Cummins can take a second bounce. Beams did well to create position, finds Karnesis. Now is a chance of the Lions as Buchanan can load up from 40 out. Puts it goalward and slaps through his first for the day. Aim on Buchanan in his last game for the Brisbane Lions. Gets his first on the board and ties the scores here at Yeronga. 2 goals, 12 each of 2, 7.5 minutes into the opening quarter of the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final.
Well, that's 2 goals in 3 minutes to the Lions, and both have come very, very similar. They're on opposite sides of the ground, but both times we've got terrific run off halfback. They ran in numbers. Good work by young Cummins. He's a Western Magpies top-up player from out in the western suburbs of Brisbane.
Yes, and, know them well.
He showed plenty of confidence there. Rosie is generally a terrific tackler, but he lost his feet, and as we know, that important to keep your feet at any game, but particularly grand finals. And good composure by Cummins, drew the man, set up the goal for Buchanan. Beautiful finish.
So the ball bounced again. Longer got high. Tyrrell just stayed down and got the tap. Chance for the Thunder out of the middle of the ground. They go inside forward 50. Ewing was the target. Just couldn't quite take the mark. And taking it at the back of the pack was Justin Clark. So the Thunder again with the clearance. This time it was the new father and Jake Dignan that got the clearance. But now it's the Lions deep inside their defensive half. Patrick Karnesis can kick up onto the centre wing, does well. Now they're moving again. Here's Buchanan, can kick up towards forward 50. No one at home for the Lions. It's a problem sometimes when you press so hard. If you get the ball on a rebound, there's no one at home. And Jason Rowe did beautifully to find his skipper and Cameron Islett across halfback. Thunder wasting no time either. Move the ball forward down the line. Now can kick towards half forward, ill directed, but in the end it's okay. Karnesis just gets up. In fact, it wasn't. It was Noah McKeever. Just fell over and then just popped up and picked out the handball at the crucial moment. Now this is Ruska. Been busy early, tries to find Islett, had to make him work for it. Good tackling by Scott Clark as well. Puts Ruska, puts Islett down close to the boundary line. Thankfully for the Thunder, the ball goes over for a boundary throw in just on the Lions' forward side of centre square.
Yeah, couldn't quite step the young fella from the Western Magpies then, Islett, but he's been busy, which is a good sign for the Thunder. Again, stacks on the mill. There's plenty of players getting involved in there. Good to see Dignan starting to touch the football, as we know he missed last week.
Mm.
And we get ourselves a bounce. Scores locked up at 2 goals apiece. About to end a time on in the first quarter. It's Longer in the ruck up against the Thunder's Tyrrell. He's already had himself a rest. Buchanan's starting to work his way into this game and have an impact. It was Buchanan to Hawksley, back to Buchanan on the trusty left, going downfield. Michael couldn't quite get his hands to the ball as tap again. That's his third or fourth big defensive spoil of the game, and we'll get ourselves a throw in. Been impressive, Sean Tapp.
He has. I think he only played the last 3 or 4 games of the season as well, so he's probably just starting to come into the peak of his powers at the moment.
That was Tyrrell over the top. This is Rioli who's been impressive. Down to McEwen. McEwen, oh, that's come off the side of the boot. Out of bounds on centre wing here, and it'll be a free kick to come back in to the Lions. Well, some of the younger players in this game, particularly this young man, Doherty, have been particularly impressive. Karnesis has also won himself a ton of football, and he's starting to become more effective as he's won the ball here with the short kick. He's got another man on. He's got Cornelius on the lead. Oh, put it out in front of him, but he couldn't get a handle on it. Oh, Williams is going to be penalised for a high tackle. Was probably a touch clumsy, but a very, very fortunate in the same vein for Cornelius, who should have wrapped that up. but he's going to have himself a shot almost on the boundary line from 45 to 48 metres out.
Aaron Cornelius has got the talent to play regular AFL football. It's just sometimes he lets his work ethic slide a little bit, as he did there, Ronnie.
He did all the hard work to get there. Can be a good kick, Cornelius. Let's show you what he does with this one. It's coming back nicely on the wind, but tap again. Make sure that it's rushed through for the first behind of this grand final, and the Lions reserves take a 1-point lead. 2-1 plays two goals, with Jason Roeder bing the ball back in, and we'll see if he loads up with one of those trademark torpedoes or whether he goes short and towards the pocket as comes traditional. Yeah, he's got the short lead on. Goes to Jack Lawler. Lawler played some terrific football with Morningside and was being touted as a draft pick at one stage before breaking a leg. He's gone to Dunn, who's kicked plenty of goals, but he's worked his way up. It was an ugly-looking kick at the feet of Lockwood. Conversely, Conway chopped up, but he's been chopped off. This is Wanamiri on the fly. Long kick that's
great
through.
Goal.
Great goal. It wasn't Wanamiri.
Anywhere. I think it might have been Ash Duncan, was it?
No, it was Patrick Heenan.
Patrick Heenan, that's it.
Heenan's intercepted that beautifully and finished off really, really well, and the Thunder are back in front. 21 minutes into the first quarter here at Yeronga, and it's the Thunder, 3 goals straight, 18, making the most of their opportunities compared to the Lions, 2-1-13. It's a very competitive contest at the moment. Neither side looks like they're going to take the game by the scruff of the neck, and it would be terrific if we have a finish like this, Sean.
Oh, it certainly would be. Great work by the Thunder that time, just popping up, and it was almost a comedy of errors a little bit at half forward, but really good touch of the football there. Got it over to Heenan, who was able to run in and kick the goal. So good tap down by Verncombe, who's moved into the ruck this time for the Thunder. It's going to be a free kick, is it? I thought the umpire was... Normally when they're that quick on the whistle, they've paid something, but they just realised that Jakey Dignam wasn't going anywhere with the football, so they're going to bounce it. So it's Longa versus Verncombe again. This time Longa got the tap. Again, Dignan's over the football. Nothing changed in that regard. Umpire let it go. The football did come out, but it only went out about 3 more centimetres before in the end he's decided that he's going to have the football as the yellow boots of Matthew Rozier get off the bottom of the pack for the Thunder. Very easy player to spot because of those yellow boots too. I like them very much as a commentator. Good work by Longa. Got the tap for the Lions. Thunder, Rozier that is, spun himself out of trouble, now gets the handball going forward. This is Vassal, the best and fairest in the Western Border League in Country Victoria last year. Kicks in towards the forward pocket, close to the boundary line where the football eventually goes over. We'll have a throw in just in front of the players' change sheds here at Leyshon Park in Yeronga. It is the Thunder by 5 points deep into this first quarter. We've played 23 and a half minutes.
So it's Lockwood up against Longa. Longa wins the tap from behind down to the front. Vassal couldn't get a handle on it. Ball spills there. That was looked like a scramble kick forward there by McEwen. Top of the ball, there's Wanamiri. That's not going to come out in a hurry.
Nope.
And as we've seen on numerous occasions in this first quarter, we're going to get ourselves a bounce up in the attacking 50 for the NT Thunder. They lead by 5 points. Almost the 23-minute mark of this first quarter. Big fly by Will Farrer down the throat of Rozier, but he's quickly wrapped up, and we'll get ourselves another ball up.
Doesn't mind getting a high with that leap, does Willie Farrer. He tried a couple of times in the preliminary final last week, and as you mentioned, last year's grand final, he put an aerial display on as well, Ronnie.
Oh, yeah. These pilot skills were magnificent to watch there last year. I'm sure Thunder fans would like to see that happen again as they ball's up there for contest again. Hawksley whips the ball out. Got a runner there. It can't get a handle on it. Argus is in there. Umpire's seen a free kick. Lions player was slung. No, he's found a free kick to a Thunder player. Looks like Lachlan Argus for his first touch of the day. Started the game on the interchange bench.
He's backing himself as well. He's going to kick this from just inside 50 with a slight breeze at his back.
Kicked 13 goals in a NT Thunder reserves game last season up in Darwin. Goal umpire gets under it, just fades just at the last minute, and the Thunder have got their first blemish for the day, so the lead extends out to 6 points. It's 3-1, plays 2-1. 25-minute mark of the first quarter, and Steve Wrigley about to bring the ball back in for the Brisbane Lions.
So Wrigley, a member of the NEAFL team of the year in the back pocket, made his AFL debut this season. Just waiting for the options at the moment. Thunder have got it pretty well covered one-on-one, so he has to go to a pack of players. Good work at ground level. Thunder can bring the ball back inside forward 50 here. They go backwards to go forwards through Lockwood. Kicks in the direction of Lockie Argus, but it's too close to the boundary line and again goes over for another boundary throw-in. So we're about 35 metres around from the Thunder goal. 3 opening quarter goals, 2 to Darren Ewing and 1 to Paddy Heenan. The ball's thrown back in. Longer got the tap down, but the Thunder squirt it forward, almost worked by Farah. At ground level, falling over, got the handball into traffic. Dignan couldn't keep his feet. Now around the corner, Brad Vassell in the goal square. Ewing tried to get high, couldn't do so. It's going to get rushed through. One behind to the Thunder. 3-2-20 they go to. 2-1-13 are the Brisbane Lions. Almost 26 minutes gone.
Well, Cameron Islett looks like he's gone forward and won that hard ball there against Doherty, so he'll be a different proposition than what Wanamiri was. But the Thions are relieving there. Lyle made the move. It's come to him off hands, off the pack. All the Thunder players flew up in the air. Comes down there looking for Horsley, but Jason Rowe, who's played terrific defensive first quarter of football, he's just attacked the football on every occasion, taken from position at every opportunity, and he's forced the ball into a neutral boundary throw-in position.
Jordan Lyle probably rewarded for laziness then. He stayed down from the pack. Whether he read it the better or not, because he ended up with the football, one could argue.
Well, Dignan gave it to Argus. Ball comes down to half forward, looking for Farrah, and he's got both hands to it, and it stuck that time. Looked like he was in terrific position to score a goal there 30 seconds earlier, but he made no mistake on this occasion, and he's going to shoot from about 48 metres out. Angle shouldn't be too much of a problem.
It's a very crucial goal too in the shadows of the quarter-time siren. This had put them 13 points out.
Good work around the clearance there by the Thunder. They worked the ball beautifully under pressure. So it's Will Farrah, kicked 3 goals, 3 in the grand final last year. Goal umpire doesn't move. Tyrrell declared it early. Crowd likes it. That's a goal for the Thunder. They move to 4-2-26. Double the score of the Lions reserves, 2-1-13. And that trend that we spoke about before the game of the NT Thunder winning their first quarters, the last 10 of them, looks like prevailing, Sean.
It does indeed. 4-2-26, as we mentioned, the Northern Territory. They've done it in two so far. They kicked the first 2 goals. The Lions came back with the next 2. And then, as we've just seen, inside the time on period, Heenan and Farrah kicking goals for the NT Thunder. They just seem to be winning the ball more in the midfield at the moment. Dignan and Islett getting some key touches, especially at clearances. And that's what's propelling the Thunder forward in this game as the ball's bounced once again. Longer kind of got it on the way down, but Tyrrell sharks it. Good tackle that time by Beams. He's going to get the free as well.
Yeah, great tackle by the little man on the big man too, but it was again Cameron Islett who got his hands on the ball first.
So Clay Beams. Long kick inside forward, 50, good mark by Cornelius. Just plucked it out that time, stood his ground well and takes the mark, and he'll shoot from just outside 40 metres for a chance for his first Ronnie.
And that's the matchup that the Lions should be looking to expose. Williams Jr. Is not a big man.
Nope.
Cornelius is. He's a very strong man and he's got very, very strong hands. So if they can get that one out, that one-on-one between those two players, you're going to back Cornelius 9 times out of 10, and that's going to be a problem for the Thunder.
So Ace Cornelius. Parents christened him Aaron. Just kicks it off to the right-hand side, though. Through for one behind. Led off for the Thunder as the Lions 2-2-14 trail the Thunder 4-2-26. 28 and a half minutes gone in this opening quarter. And a quick kick out by the Thunder, Ronnie.
Well, Taps got away from Michael, looking for his former Zilmir mate, Argus. Did he claim it? No, the boundary umpire is saying he took the second grab over the boundary line.
Yeah,
boundary
probably umpire the right call in the end as well.
Yeah, boundary umpire was right on the spot. Get ourselves a boundary throw in between wing and half forward for the Thunder. Big Tyrrell takes front position. Could have been interfered with, wasn't, but it doesn't matter because he butted up beautifully. Gave it to Matty Argus. Puts it out in front of McEwen. Good spoil there by Wynn. And we're going to get ourselves another boundary throw in front of the salubrious palatial AFLQ offices here at downtown Yeronga.
Matty Argus has had some key touches in this first quarter so far. He's been amongst probably the best 2 or 3 for the Thunder so far.
Tyrrell did that beautifully despite being taken to ground. Buchanan's come in there and won the ball though for the Lions. Ball's popped up and he's back in there again with a strong tackle, Eamon Buchanan. And we're going to get ourselves a boundary throw in. 43 touches in the qualifying final win over Southport for Eamon Buchanan. He was unstoppable that day. Be looking for something similar again as Tyrrell again wins the knockout. Buchanan runs toward it, but Dunn gets over it, fishes the ball out, but it only goes as far as the feet of Cummins. Buchanan, that was composed, gives it to Beams, who's been busy. Comes downfield here looking for Michael, and he's got the break on Tap. Looks like the move may have been made because Tap was dominating there at centre-half back early. Moved Lyle up the ground. This is Cornelius. He's got Bartlett running for him. Will it bounce for the Lions? No, it won't. We'll get ourselves a boundary throw in the Lions forward 50. We haven't seen the ball down in the Lions forward 50 a lot. I think if we looked at the percentages, we would see that it's certainly been forward for the Thunder for a lot more percentage of the games. It's been very difficult with the amount of players around the ball. And again, we've got a big swarm of players around this one. Tyrrell was thrown to the ground. No free kick. This tap gives it away towards Williams. He's got it off to Wanamiri. Ball comes out here towards Islet, who's been busy looking for Lockwood. That's not going to help him. Good ball by Niall McKeever, who hasn't touched the ball a lot, but he's been very, very defensive there and not allowed Lockwood to be much of an influence on the game thus far.
As a defender, it doesn't matter too much if you don't touch it. If your man doesn't get a kick, you'll be in the best players.
Now, the Lions had all the numbers around the ball, but Vassals won it off the hands of McEwen. He's going long. Ewing was in the best position to mark. And Ewing, the ball's, we said that the ball's going to carry on that wing, on that wind. Ewing knew that, got the drop on Clark and has taken the mark about 6 metres out from goal, and he's going to shoot for number three. We're at the 31 minute mark of the first quarter, so there can't be too much time left, and this will be a most valuable goal for the NT Thunder. The underdogs, they've got their fifth. They move to 5-2-32. They've got a clean 3-goal break on the Lions reserves 2-2-14, and that is just what the doctor ordered for the Thunder, who are travelling for the second week in a row. They had to come down to the Gold Coast last week to play the preliminary final. Certainly done it the hard way, but they're looking particularly impressive this early in the game, Sean.
They are indeed, and great clearance work by the Thunder that time. Just got it and pumped it long and almost caught the Lions' defence napping a little bit that time. Just the experience of Darren Ewing to push off at the crucial moment and take the mark. Fantastic work by the NT Thunder and Team of the Year forward. And it's given his team a handy break. I talked about in the shadows of quarter time about 8 minutes ago, it feels like. We're crossing over 32 minutes, just about to, and you think there wouldn't be too long left in this opening quarter.
Well, we talked about the Cornelius-Williams matchup. It's starting to look like the Clark-Ewing matchup is proving very, very valuable for the NT Thunder at this early stage of the game. So
you wonder if Niall McKeever will get the job in the second quarter if it continues in this vein.
Well, that was Scott Clark who's won the clearance. Look for Cummins. Oh, big hit there by Vassell. Thunder are wrapped up. Oh, he's going to be pinned for holding the ball there. Patrick Karnesis is going to win the free kick against Rosier. Let's see, this is Buchanan. See if the Lions can score before the siren goes. Big fly from the back by Hawksley. Couldn't get a handle on it. McEwen runs in looking for it. Buchanan busts the pack. Comes out toward Vassell. Good work in close again by the Thunder. The handball work's been in close has been good. And the Lions, did they play on the umpire? They did play on. The umpire said that was advantage. And so we've got ourselves quarter time here. And the underdogs have got themselves a very nice little 3-goal break at quarter time. It's the NT Thunder 5-2-32, lead the Lions reserves 2-2-14, and I'd suggest, Sean, both coaches have got a little bit to think about in terms of the positions for the second term.
They do indeed. Goal kickers for the Thunders in that first quarter, Darren Ewing with 3 singles to Farrah and Heenan, and for the Lions, Amon Buchanan and Jack Crisp, their goal kickers. Quarter time here in the NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final. It is the NT Thunder out by 3 goals, 5-2-32, leading the Lions 2-2-14. We're going to take a break from here at Leishon Park in Yeronga, take some of our sponsor messages here on Thunder Vision, and we'll be back very shortly with all of the second quarter action from what has been a great grand final so far in the NEAFL. We'll be back very shortly here on Thunder Vision.
Thank you for this great opportunity to build the ICTHIS LNG project in the Territory. That's why we're giving back to the community.
Students across Northern Australia now have access to more trade skills here in Darwin.
Oil and gas training and research are now available at our university because of this world-class project.
And more than $14 million has been injected into local roads.
We're committed to growing the Territory, so let's take this journey together.
ICTHIS, securing the future.
Authorised by ICTHIS LNG Proprietary Limited, Perth. Palmerston Public Golf Course is a picturesque and challenging championship course, located just 16 minutes from Darwin CBD, at the very heart of Palmerston. The course features PGA qualified coaching and a fully equipped golf shop for all your golfing needs and custom club fittings. It's the perfect setting for a corporate day or a casual round, any day of the week. Palmerston Public Golf Course, at the very heart of Palmerston.
Right, just a reminder to people that half-time there will be some half-time entertainment on the ground. So again, spectators, if you can keep the ground clear, that would be much appreciated. Thank you.
Welcome back to the NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final here from Leyshon Park in Yeronga. It's quarter time and it's the NT Thunder 18-point leaders. They're 5-2-32. The Brisbane Lions 2-2-14 at the first break in this game. As we mentioned, Darren Ewing, three goals for the Thunder in the first quarter. He's been a tower of strength up forward. Sean Kelly and Ron McDonald bringing you the coverage of the game today on Thunder Vision. And Ronnie, how have you seen this game so far? Obviously, the Thunder three goals ahead and quite deservedly so, in my opinion.
Yeah, well, they kicked the last three goals of the first quarter to give themselves that advantage, but I think it was their clearance work. We spoke about that during the break, that their clearance work has been particularly impressive. You would have thought, against the AFL quality standard, there's 12 Brisbane Lions players have played senior football in the AFL this year, that the Lions might be a little bit too strong around the ball, but it's been the reverse so far. Been particularly impressed with the Thunder's composure. They're certainly not being overawed by the occasion. I know they were there last year, but they've looked very, very cool under pressure. As up they go, Longa got over the top of Tyrrell on that occasion. Rosier gets his hand to the ball first. This is Dignan who's worked his way in after a slow start. Beams, who's been good from the start for the Lions, just bounced away from him. Rioli, geez, had some effective little possessions. That's Islet, who's enjoyed his best game against the Lions for a while. Certainly a best start. Vassal runs onto it, looking for an inside runner. Wasn't there forthcoming. This is Fox, the youngster from the Western Magpies. Gives it up towards Hawksley, but it was a poor disposal. Bounced up. The Thunder got the intercept, but they've given it up again. Coming down towards half forward. That was Cornelius. Was he pushed under the football? The Lions coach's box certainly wanted in the back, but that wasn't forthcoming.
Definitely and Williams, two movements.
And Williams has taken the mark. Gone to Rowe, the experienced veteran who was so good, close to the best player on the ground. And we will see the Joe Grant medal awarded. Never been a dual Joe Grant medal winner.
Jackie Dignan, come on down.
Dignan will be looking for. Stiller dishes off there. This is Karnesis, who's been prominent. Gave it to Beams. Beams has got the runner. There's that run and overlap from the Lions again. Cornelius took front position, but it overshot him. Williams was good. This is Tapp, who's mopped up well all game. Goes out the way towards Duncan. This is Dignan, the man we were talking about. Had to kick quickly and didn't look, and he's given it straight towards Longa. This is Weirden, the youngster. On the left foot, he's got a man out wide there in Hawksley. Hawksley marks at half forward for the Lions, who are looking to bridge this three-goal margin, kicking to what we believe is the scoring end.
So Hawksley long from half forward, inside forward 50. Thunder get the numbers back. Tyrrell drops the mark. He's got support at ground level. Rioli just got the little touch. Couldn't quite keep effectiveness. Free kick, though, going the way of the Lions. Interesting. The player holding, they've called over the shoulder. The player holding his head on the bottom of the pack was Shannon Rusker. But the free kick's going to go the way of the Brisbane Lions, deep in their scoring zone. And their chance to kick the first goal of the quarter is with Jack Fox.
Well, big Kenrick Tyrrell was obviously angry with himself for dropping that mark, and he has just charged into the pack. And there's a bit of friendly fires taken out Shannon Rusker as well. But in the way that the umpires umpire the game these days, there was never any question that was going to be a free kick to the Lions, and they've got the opportunity to get a confidence-boosting goal just 2 minutes into this second quarter. The goal umpire hasn't moved. He's made no mistake, the youngster. So he gets reward for courage for putting his head over the football with the big man charging at him. The Lions move to 3-2-20. The Thunder are 5-2-32. We've got ourselves a very, very interesting game of football on our hands.
You certainly do, as the Lions draw first blood in the second quarter, reducing the Thunder's lead to 12 points.
Breaks that sequence of three consecutive goals for the Thunder, and we all know that if you can string goals together, it can certainly break open football games.
Certainly can, as the ball returns to the centre of Leishon Park in Yeronga.
Couple of mistakes, error-riddled passages of football by both teams there, and they'll be looking to make sure that that doesn't happen again.
Yeah, not one to rewatch again on the DVD in the coming days for both sides, as Islet tried to come away with the football, so did Dignan, neither could. Now it's with Bartlett. Gets the handball out to the running player, running onto it nicely with Shaney Stiller. Went inside forward 50, good tackle that time by the Thunder's Ash Duncan. Now the line spearing pass finds its target, and a good mark taken by, is that Scott Clark that's shifted forward? I think it might be, the man that played on Darren Ewing in the first quarter, a chance to get a goal of his own as he lines this one up from 40 metres out.
It was Justin Clark who's got those Clarks.
The Clark boys are confusing me.
You there.
One's 42 and one's 52, so it's even more confusing. So this is Scott Clark. Kicks on its way, looks okay, does it? No, he's just pushed it across the face and threw 4-1 behind. So it's 3-3-21 Lions, 5-2-32 Thunder, 4 minutes gone in this second quarter of the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final.
And the Thunder are going to have their hands full, because you can just look by the body language and the intensity of a few of the senior players there from the Brisbane Lions that they've really come out to play in this second quarter. As Tyrrell makes no mistake with that mark, that's a big, strong pack mark.
And he got the assist by Jed Anderson then as well, who kind of phantomed up behind him, so it blocked out the defenders from taking Kenrick Tyrrell.
So Tyrrell looks downfield, not a long on offer. It's an ugly-looking kick off the boot, goes only as far as Niall McIver. Made his name in a state game for Queensland last year against Western Australia. Rowe with a big defensive fist. Duncan gives it back to him. Now he can go downfield and start something up. Goes very wide looking for Farrer on a long, long lead. Ball's not going to go that far.
Well done.
Brilliantly intercepted there. Was that Fox again?
Might have been.
But the handball wasn't quite as impressive. Actually, might have been Beams.
As usual, good stuff happens on the opposite side of the ground to where we are.
Umpire's found himself a free kick. He's gone for holding the ball, and the Thunder are going to get the relieving free kick. It's difficult to see against the merge of spectators on that very low hill over there on that side of the ground as Ben Rioli just pops the ball good up for Lockwood. That was a very, very clever kick. Kicked Lockwood into the ball. So he can load up big, big numbers again getting behind the ball. He's looking for an option. There's not a lot forthcoming, so he goes inboard towards Williams, who's run up from the half-back line. And Williams goes back now looking for an option. The Lions have got the men across the middle, so he's not going to be able to go the switch. So instead he gives it to Rowe and says, you think about it, Rowe. Boof, Ewing's on the lead. That's a magnificent kick by Jason Rowe. That's just terrific football by the man who played senior football for both Collingwood and the Brisbane Lions. Speared it onto the chest of Ewing. Did well to create the space there because there were plenty of men back there, plenty of defenders back there by the Lions. So Darren Ewing is going to line up for number four.
Probably the two best players on the ground at the moment linked up there. One at one end of the ground at full back and the other at full forward.
So the Breeze is going to push that across goal. The degree of difficulty just with the way the Breeze was pushing that, he had to aim for the right-hand goal post. And it slid across goal four or behind to extend the lead out to two even goals, 6 minutes into the second quarter.
So the Lions just waiting for their target now again. The Thunder go man on man from the kick-ins. So just has to parlay the ball to himself and then comes towards the commentary side wing. Conway was his target, but Vernkham was there to take the mark in a two-on-one. Slips the ball into the centre of the ground. Finds a teammate. Now Lawler can go inside forward 50 at the fall of the ball. This is Islet. Tries to keep it in against Doherty. Couldn't do so. We'll have a boundary throw in about 48 metres around from the Thunder goal.
Clever body work there by Cameron Islet. He just didn't get the bounce. It bounced on the point and bounced away from him.
So the ball thrown back in front of the pack that time. Lockwood got the tap for the Thunder. It's going to go nowhere from the stoppage. The umpire jumps onto it straight away and says, I'll have this one. We'll have another secondary ball up.
Gee, Islet really attacked that ball again, put his head down and went through like a rampaging bull.
Did that last week. Just a couple of times where he needed to stand up last week, Cameron Islet kicked the captain's goals when Southport were charging in the preliminary final as longer. Got the tap down for the Lions, but again, it's going absolutely nowhere. And again, we're going to have a secondary ball up. So it's inside forward 50 for the Thunder, kicking to the left of screen, the city end in this quarter. Lockwood over the top, got the tap at the Lions, shark it, kick in the Cornelius direction, went one-handed, couldn't control it in the end. Now the Thunder have got the numbers. Nice little handball by Vernkham, finds Jason Rowe. Shimmies once, shimmies twice, then gets taken down as he kicks it. Lockwood's trying to protect the area. Coming in hard that time was Farrah from the back of the pack for the Thunder. In the end, the ball's at ground level. The Lions get it out. This is McKeever. Gives it to Karnesis. Now finds Weirden back to Karnesis. Kicks in our general direction in the commentary box, which doesn't really affect any of the Lions players. Rowe, little tap over the top. Beams did well. Got the kick away before being taken down. Isaac Conway leads in the race for it. Picks the ball up nicely. Handball inside forward 50. Now this is Fox, can have a shot at goal from the wrong side really, and puts it through for one behind. It's 3-4-22 Lions, 5-3-33 Thunder. 8.5 minutes gone, third quarter. As I was calling that, Ronnie, there was a little bit of a tete-a-tete just in front of our commentary position.
Yeah, a little bit of a how-to-do between Beams and Matty Argus there, and but very careful with one of the jumper punches there by the Brisbane Lions player.
Yes.
But got away with it. This is Lyle. Spins around onto the left, but he's got time to steady up onto the right. Measures it. Not going to quite come back far enough. And another minor score to the Lions. Certainly their intensity is lifted. We saw that from the minute this quarter started. They still trail by 11 points. They're looking very, very threatening. Rowe is going to bring the ball in. He was very heavily dealt with too after he kicked the ball there a minute ago. So the Lions certainly intent on putting physical pressure on their opponents.
So Jason Rowe taking his time. Lions doing all of the attacking so far in this second quarter. Rowe starts, stops, has to play the ball to himself. Could have worked himself into a bit of trouble. Ends up turning around. One-on-one contest. Tap against Conway. Tap did well. Now the cavalry comes in to support him. Good pick up at ground level. What a great tackle by Isaac Conway. Bundles the ball over the boundary line. Two-on-one contest there. Isaac Conway, the young man, stood up from Apsley Football Club. Stood up and did beautifully then.
Well, talked about as the potential state under-18 captain for next year for the Queensland Scorpions as young Conway. So that's big raps on him. As Longa wins the tap. Rusker puts his head down. So does Vassal. Unlucky not to get a free kick last time, but that's clever hands by Hawksley to Beams. That's great, a magnificent kick by Clay Beams. We're talking about better players on the ground. Clay Beams is certainly up there as one of them. And that was a magnificent finish. Very, very clean hands in tight again by the Brisbane Lions reserves. And that was an area where the Thunder were particularly impressive in the first quarter. The Lions have stepped it up and they nail trail by just the 4 points. 5-3 plays 4-5. And we're 10 minutes into the second quarter of the NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final.
It's the work from stoppages that has been the key in this game for both sides so far. In the first quarter, the Thunder had the better of it. But as you just saw that time, the Lions got clear from the stoppages and Clay Beams, the beautifully weighted kick, is certainly putting his name in discussion for the top two or three players on the ground at the moment.
Well, Lawler's gone into the middle to look after Karnesis. Beams is there again. This is Karnesis wins the kick out. Duncan gets a fist to it, but it's going to spill straight to Hawksley, who was involved in the last play. Hawksley won't make any mistake. He's a very skilled footballer, and in the blink of an eye, we've got the Brisbane Lions hitting the front. They move to 5-5, 35. The NT Thunder of 5-3-33, and that goal came in less than 30 seconds from the restart, and they've kicked three in a row, the Lions, and they're very much in this game, and all of a sudden it's the Thunder who are going to have to start to look at stemming the bleeding.
Yeah, the Thunder would want to do over on that one. There was a couple of efforts that time that if they had their time again, they'd go much harder at the football. We talked about Lawler coming into the middle to mine Karnesis. It was Karnesis that got the clearance, and then just a weak one-hander that time, allowing Hawksley to run onto an open football, and 30 metres between him and the goal with nothing there, just a run in and kick his first for the day.
So Scott Clark's gone into the ruck. He's up against Viancombe. Clark wins the tap down. This is Beams again, but it only goes far as Lawler. The umpire Aaron Hall's found himself a free kick. But he's given it to Beams. Beams, who's certainly giving the Lions plenty of drive. He goes up and goes long. Puts the pressure on the defence. Or almost a mark there towards Lyle. But it's come down to ground level. Magnificent handball out. And that's young Fox. He's got his second for the quarter. And the Lions go further ahead. Three goals in 3 minutes at the 9, 10 and 11 minute mark. And they've moved to 6-5-41. The NT Thunder of 5-3-33. And like you said, Sean, those centre clearances are proving very, very important.
It was. And they also had a lot of numbers at the fall of the football inside the forward line. That time you knew that once the ball hit the deck, something was going to happen, because the Lions, Hawksley just about was in the perfect position. Just couldn't quite pick the footy up. They managed to squeeze it over to Fox, who put a nice little kick on a ball that dribbled through. His second for the quarter. We talked about the Lions looking threatening. They've gone beyond threatening. You'd almost say dominant in this quarter at the moment.
So it's Clark up against Viancombe again. They've been very good at the centre clearances on the last three occasions, the Lions. What will they do this time? Clark wins it again. He was looking for Beams, but it bounced past him, but that doesn't matter because Dyson chipped in. He's got the outrider there in Stiller on that trusty left foot. Oh, Cornelius couldn't get a handle on it. This is Fox again. Hasn't he been busy? Rowe applies the tackle to him, but he's good enough to get the handball out. It's wrapped up this time by Rioli. Duncan's in there. Rowe's in there to help. Ball spills out. Calling for a free kick. Push, says umpire Baldwin. And Jason Rowe, as he has done all game, will take the relieving free kick for the Thunder, who in the blink of an eye find themselves trailing by 8 points.
So Rowe goes straight up the line with the kick on a long lead. A nice mark taken by Lachlan Argus. So Argus at half back now. Needs to look for options further afield. There's not really anyone presenting, so he goes down the line in the Dignan direction. Gets front spot. Couldn't take the mark. Pack forms over the football again. We're going to have another stoppage. No, we've called a holding the ball.
That's a good decision. Yeah. The Lions player couldn't get his punching hand to the ball, so it was just stuck in the one hand. So good decision by the umpire. So
it's a free kick going the way of the Thunder. Kick inside forward 50. Pack flies. Now the ball hits the ground. Where's the runners for the Thunder? Do a nice little pick up. Sneak around the corner in the Wanamiri direction. Ewing tried to put the block on, but in the end the football veered into a different direction and through for the Thunder's only second score of this quarter. They're 5-4-34. The Lions are 6-5-41. As you can see, almost 14 minutes gone in this second quarter.
The Thunder are going to have to do something about that man, Beams. I've been watching him for the last 2 minutes, and he's been running through the centre of the ground by himself, and that is where the kick went. Now, Lyle's over the back of the pack. This is going to be another easy goal to the Brisbane Lions reserves. That's the way it goes. They've moved that ball so quickly, caught the Thunder out, and it was Beams who's done it again. He's been pivotal in almost every goal this quarter, and that's the seventh for the Lions. 7-5, 5-4. That's a 13-point margin, and we're still only 14 minutes into this second quarter. quarter, and the Lions are kicking to that scoring end of the ground, but they've put the turbochargers on. Let's just try and have a look at where Beams has gone to, but he's come off to the bench for a well-earned rest, so it might be a chance now for the Thunder to claim back a little bit of the momentum.
And they say you make your own luck in this game, but sometimes luck falls your way when you've got a bit of a run on, and that's exactly what happened that time. The handball from Cornelius was actually smothered by the Thunder, but it fell into the path of Jordan Lyle, who was able just to get a nice touch on the football and put the ball through as well. So luck can be a fortune, but you also make your own luck in very many cases in this game. The ball's up again. Tyrrell back into the ruck for the Thunder, but it's Karnesis that takes it out of the middle. Gives the handball inside forward 50, but an ill-directed kick and a mark taken by Damian Williams Jr. Switches on if he wants it. That's where he's going to go. He's going to go backwards to come forwards. Duncan, he'll find Tyrrell. Tyrrell's got some space and he can take the mark uncontested. Now comes outside forward 50. Got bumped by Buchanan as he kicked it. Just enough off the football that McKeever could take the uncontested mark. So Noah McKeever. Interesting looking football drop that time, but finds Buchanan. Takes on Rosier, kicks inside forward 50. Cornelius on the long leg. Good work by Rowe, just to stand in front of the fact it wasn't Cornelius at all. Good pick up at ground level by the Lions. This is where they're dangerous. Kick around the corner that time by Dyson. Just didn't have much on it. And Jason Rose there once again to mop up. Looked in a couple of directions before deciding on the good option and ends up finding it in Jack McEwen. So McEwen across half back, takes a bounce, can launch down the line towards half forward. Long lead that time and a nice mark taken by Willie Farrer. So Farrer, as the Thunder try to get something going, he's got Rosier on this side if he wants it. Started that way, then gave it over to Heenan. Heenan inside forward 50, nice mark taken. Good work by the Thunder, close to the boundary line underneath the scoreboard. And it's going to be Lachlan Argus that's taken the mark, and he can have a shot for his first of the day.
They still look like they're working harder, running towards both ends at the moment, the Lions reserves. There was a pack of Lions reserves players running back trying to clog up the space there, but it was just the immaculate foot skills of Austin Wanamiri who put the ball on the chest of Lachlan Argus.
So Argus, I called him Paddy Heenan, sorry Aussie, goes with the right foot. Goal umpire has to work to the left, had to work too far in the end, and it's 3-1 behind. 5-5-35 the Thunder, 7-5-47 the Lions. It's a 12-point ball game here at Leyshon Park in Yeronga in the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final.
I'd suggest that's not the attacking side of the ground, even though you would think it is. Balls looks like, and even from watching the players before the game having shots kicking at goal, it looks like it's easier to kick goals from the left-hand pocket rather than the right-hand. Something the Thunder might want to consider as Dignan's taken off the ball. No free kick forthcoming, so Buchanan gets it out, but it's gone as far as Lockwood. Can he get a handle on it? He's under pressure. That was Eden Anderson went in there, but Buchanan's won it for the Lions reserves. Puts it at the feet of a teammate there in Clark. It's come to Ewing. Oh, good tackle there at the very, very last minute by Buchanan there, who's butted up in about three passages of play. Here's the running McKeever, who's been really effective at centre-half back. Not the greatest kick, but it's found Conway. He goes down there looking for a teammate in Fox, but Duncan chips in front of him. Can't get a handle on it. Oh, it's a pretty awful handball. So Conway's going to run back onto it. Oh, good speed there by Rioli. He doesn't win it, but it opens it up for Duncan, well, who gives it back to Rioli. Looks downfield. He's got Wanamiri open. Doherty goes over the top. It's got to be a free kick to the Lions player. No, the umpire says that was a shepherd. So there's going to be a free kick. Oh, no, it wasn't a shepherd. It was to a Clark.
So it was Clark taking the mark. Kicks up the line. Thunder have got numbers at the football. Can bump it inside forward 50 once again. Doherty attack the football hard. It's going to come down to the back of the pack. Chance for the Thunder if they can pick it up. But going over the boundary line and over the fence was Lachlan Argus. And we're going to have a boundary throw in deep in the NT Thunder's attacking area.
They trial by 2 goals, the Thunder. They're looking to score from this opportunity. Just scored they haven't scored a goal this quarter. They've moved from 5-2 to 5-5. Just the 3 behinds as Rosier tries to take the ball but thinks better of it. Buchanan comes out of it holding his head. McKeever's got himself another possession. It comes back to Buchanan. He can't stop getting touches. Gives it to Karnesis. Here comes that run from half back again. Yo takes them on. Charges past 2 players. Takes a bounce. He can go again if he wants. He can have a third. No, he'll steady and shoot from 35. And just fate at the last minute. Gee, that would have been a goal of the year. Defender punches the turf in frustration. Does young Elliot Yeo, young man from Western Australia, extends the lead to 13 points. And that was breathtaking stuff, Sean.
It was indeed. As I just take a breath watching it. Oh, interesting kick in that time by Rowe. End up finding its target in Anderson. Feeds back to Rioli. Now Rioli goes one way, then the other. Gives to Anderson, who had in support. Now Rosier. They've just escaped defensive 50 now. Matty Rosier runs along the wing. Kick wasn't great. In front that time was Wrigley, but couldn't control the football. Good work by Terrell in the end. Gets the snap kick out of the pack. Two lines fly against each other. Wanamere at ground level. Couldn't pick up. McKeever did okay. Gave to Doherty. Doherty's handball wasn't great, but the numbers were there to support him. That was almost a throw out of the pack that time. Umpire said, no, it's not, Sean. You're not watching correctly. Now the Lions can go in attack. Here's a chance for Longer, who takes the uncontested mark. He's got players on in the middle of the ground if he wants it. Instead, goes straight down the line. And why not when you've got Callum Bartlett all on his own? Can kick into the middle of the ground. He's got some player as well. This is going to be Janie Stiller, who can wind up and kick a great goal for the Lions. Great unrewarded running by Janie Stiller. Got rewarded in the end. Puts his first through for the quarter. And the sixth in the row for the Lions. They move it to 8-6-54. Then teeth under a 5-5-35. We've just crossed into the time on period in this second quarter. And it's all Lions, Ronnie McDonald.
Well, they moved the ball with surgical precision on that occasion, the Lions. That was really impressive stuff. Probably the best passage of football of the day. And you give a lot of credit to Niall McKeever there at centre-half back. He was absolutely crunched by his teammate Doherty when the ball was up there for the contest. And while the ball spilled, he butted up a second and a third time and wound up getting the hard ball out to the overlap. And that started the procession. So great work there by the Irishman. As we're back in the middle, good knock there by Vincombe. But Cannon's going to win it at ground level. Beams is back on and gets into it straight away. Doherty's recovered from that knock and gives it there to Weirden. He's got an outrunner there in Dyson. Dyson's well tackled. Oh, couldn't quite hold it. The Thunder, they are certainly on the back foot as he goes downfield looking for Aaron Cornelius, and the Lions are going to have themselves yet another shot at goal. They're 8-6, the Lions. They've kicked 6 for the quarter. Cornelius hurriedly tries to get it on and registers just the minor score. But we're 21 minutes into this quarter, Sean. You'd think there's probably another 9 minutes left, and the Thunder really got to look at limiting the damage.
They do indeed. They probably need one of their own as soon as they can as well, but they almost need to go into lockdown mode as Jason Rowe is going to go long with the kick in from fullback. In the Wanamere, in the Heenan direction, sorry, he sits down. Good work gathering at the front by Dunn, who's been quiet. Kicks into the middle of the ground. There's some real estate there for Lockwood to run onto. Instead, he overruns the football. Now it doesn't at the back of the pack. This is Lockwood. I was looking at the wrong man. Kicks in the Ewing direction. Good little touch that time by Clark just to affect the course of the football. And it goes over the boundary line for a boundary throw-in. Mighty effort by Justin Clark to get his hand on the football that time, because if he didn't, Puff Ewing was running in for his fourth.
Yeah, good call. Sean Ewing looked like he was in the absolute perfect position, but just that big stretch and fingertips by the young man.
So the football thrown back in, about 35 around from the Thunder goal. Front position was Lockwood that time, got the tap down. Good work by the Thunder to bring the football out. Now they get the handball, Dignan. They're lining up for it, probably went to the wrong man. The flat-footed one gives the Lions a chance now. This is Weirden, got the little handball across half-back, but it's going to come back in with interest. Long kick towards goal for the Thunder that time's offline. 3-for-1 behind. I think that might have been Willie Farrow that had that long
that
shot, was
Jack Lawler again, Jack Lawler on the trusty left foot. Yeah, Cameron Eilert just inspired that piece of play. And it's the first time we've seen him since early in the second quarter, and they've just managed to take his limit, his influence, and that may be one of the reasons why the Lions have been so dominant through the midfield.
So the Lions off half back now. Nice presenting. I was going to say mark not paid, but free kick will be. So the Lions doing well at using this opposite side wing to our commentary spot, which is really just pleasing me greatly. As Stiller takes the uncontested mark. Now can go long inside forward 50. Longer has made space in the forward line. Ball bounces off his chest in the end. Rowe did nicely. Got tap in support. Interesting looking over the head. Handball to Rowe, who goes back to tap. Lions are putting some immense forward pressure on, trying to lock this football in. They've got one of the better outcomes. They didn't win it, but they forced a 50-50 by knocking it out over for a boundary throw in.
Yeah, the move of Sam Michael to centre half forward onto tap in place of Lyle certainly worked for the Lions reserves. He's certainly running tap around a lot more, and not allowing him to just charge through the ball and give the rebound that he was in that first quarter.
Thunder had to be careful there too, because Lyle snuck on the ground unnoticed, and if the Lions had got the ball out, he was 20 metres in the clear, 30 metres out from goal.
And taps on his haunch out, and his haunch is behind play at the moment. You don't want to see too much of that. No, he's up now. He's hobbling around a little, but he looks as though he's okay. So it's Brad Vassell. He's got Lawler out on to if he wants to switch it, and that's the way he goes. There's not a lot more on offer, so Lawler's going to have to run it.
Line.
He can only go short. short, and he's going to have to come inboard, and that's dangerous because the big man Lyle charges in front of Williams, and with the bruise at his back, he can have a shot at goal. Lyle, he's kicked 45 goals for the season.
There's times to switch, but I don't know about that one because there was nothing on further up the line for Jack Lawler.
So Lyle goes forward, just chips it up for Cornelius, who... Cornelius worked particularly hard on that passage of play. He was the one who won the mark up on the wing there 30 seconds ago. Obviously shook off his opponent, the fullback, and he's run down there. And it was Jack Lawler who was looking for him to man up on him. He had no idea when he did the runaround lead. And so Cornelius is going to shoot for goal.
I've been on him for his work ethic sometimes, but definitely not that stage. He put in a lot of work to get that football that time.
Looking to extend the margin to over four goals. Guides it more than kicks it. Oh, it's come back. Will you look at that? It'll be an interesting one. I think it's a goal. It is. There's a little bit of a word of advice from some of the people who were talking to him over the fence. And that's Aaron Cornelius' first goal of the day. And takes the Lions to 9-7. Plays 5-6. It's a 25-point advantage to the Lions reserves. We're 25 minutes into the second quarter, and the Thunder can ill afford to give away too much more of an advantage, because what we do know is that the Brisbane Lions have won 12 of their last 13 last quarters, so we know that they're going to finish with a rush, so you do not want to be behind this team anywhere near the final change.
Absolutely no doubt about that. Lions have kicked all seven goals in this second quarter. As the ball's back in the middle of the ground, some shepherding off the ball. It's going to be a free kick going to the Lions. Buchanan tried to play on with it, but it's going to come back, and it's going to be a free kick to Billy Longa. So Longa, he's been good today in the middle of the ground, really giving the Lions first use. Finds the man at centre half forward who marks. This is Clark.
Been impressive, Sean, some of his forward work.
Has indeed. Scott Clark kicks in the direction. He's got Cornelius down there as well for the ball. Bartlett just couldn't hold on to it. Thunder have got a chance if they can march this one out of the back line. Good work around level. This is Bartlett again. No look handball to Karnezis. Round the corner, high up and under with the right foot. Working his way to the front of the pack that time was Sam Michael. Couldn't mark. Going to run in, no, and snap around the corners. Jordan Lyle puts his second through for the quarter. And Lyle gets the Lions eighth in a row in this second quarter. They are all over it at this stage. They move to 10-7-67. The Thunder are 5-6-36. I was going to say danger signs for the Thunder, but those danger signs were really about 15 minutes ago. They are in trouble.
Yeah, and the bad news for the Thunder is too that they're actually looking tired. There were several players who looked tired down there in defence in that passage of play. We've still got a long, long, long way to go in this football game. The defence has been under enormous pressure. They've been asking to do a lot. And they need a little bit more help from the midfield, and particularly they need to reassess this centre clearance situation. They've got the A-team back in the middle there now, and by the A-team I mean Dignan, Cam Islett and Rosier. Let's see if they can re-arrest this supremacy that the Lions have been able to exert. So just change it around completely on the first quarter. There goes Tyrrell. He's won it to Dignan. Asks for it back. Runs through half four. Can this be their first goal of the quarter? No, the ball fades on that breeze again. He's... Doherty, who was particularly good in the first quarter, went under pressure. Lachlan Argus has looked likely down there. This is Lockwood's going to kick it around his body. He's got top of the square. Ewing's in good position to mark. Farrah flies high. Stop. At the ground level is Austin Wanamirian. Didn't they need that, the NT Thunder? It's taken all of 27 and a half minutes to get their first goal of this quarter, but they've got it, and they've brought the margin back to 25 points. And again, we talked about that centre clearance work. It seems to be that the team who wins the centre clearance wins the goal, Sean.
And as you quite rightly pointed out, they put the A-team back in the middle of the ground, and it was that A-team that worked the ball forward with a huge assist by Kenrick Tyrrell then, who was fantastic in helping and really being that link up between the midfield and pumping the ball forward. Then once they got in there, Ozzie Wanamiri working a bit of magic close to goal, and to say the Thunder needed that one is the absolute understatement of the day. If they can somehow pinch one more before half-time, they might go into this third quarter confident as Rosier gets his hands on the ball and gives to Jake Dignan. Feeds to Rowe, who comes running off half-back, goes in the Wanamiri direction. Again, great tap away though by the Lions that time, and tapping the ball and then just keeping running over the boundary line. Beautiful defensive play by the Lions.
Yeah, young Patrick Weirden, that was good good work. It's been a good battle there. Wanamiri was very quiet early as Doherty comes off for a spell. This is Tyrrell. Wins down for Dignan, but he couldn't get a handle on it. Crisp does. Handballs to no one in particular. Clark had front position, but it evaded him. This is Ruska. Possibly his last game for the Thunder. Rowe, who's been by far and away the Thunder's best player. Kicks it long down there looking for Farrah. Farrah, great set
of
hands.
He made good spot. Great. He worked into that spot beautifully then to take that mark, Ronnie. He started behind and just slipped in between the two Lions defenders that time and found himself in the perfect position to mark. And as we said, if they can get this one, they'll take some confidence into half time.
Yeah, well, just when they looked as though they were dead in the water, they've kicked again, the Thunder, but it's a very important kick. And again, they're kicking from that side of the ground. The ball's certainly been fading from right to left, so he's going to need to aim it out to the right. He has done so. That is a very clever kick by Will Farrow. He's got his second, one goal in each quarter. And the Thunder at the 29-minute mark are back in the contest. 10-7, 67, plays 7-6, 48. And again, the on-ballers, the prime on-ballers, Dignans and the Islets have been starting to get their hands on the football in the last couple of minutes and reassess their momentum.
It may have taken them a little bit to work out this Thunder midfield as well, to work out the Lions midfield as well. They've got, no surprise actually, seeing looking down to our left and seeing Eamon Buchanan sitting on the bench during this period as well. He's had a purple patch in this second quarter, and him and Clay Beams have really been probably the architects so far for the Lions. One of them comes off the ground. The Thunder get their A-team back on the ball, and all of a sudden, it's a different ball game as there's the bounce once again. Both ruckmen negate each other that time. Good work by Anderson over the football. Gets the clearance for the Thunder. Bouncing ball, McEwen thumps it inside 50. Islet, he snuck forward this time. Just tried to take the footy with him. Now they can run in and kick another goal, the Thunder. Austin Wanamiri magic again as he gets his second for the quarter. Third in 3 minutes for the Thunder. They come with a flourish late in the quarter. They move to 8-6-54. All of a sudden, it's a 13-point ball game. Lions 10-7-67.
Well, they've lifted their intensity, the Thunder. They obviously realise the gravity of the situation. Again, those prime experienced blokes. And big Kenrick Tyrrell, he's been good every occasion that he's been on the football, and he really does give them some physical presence there in the middle. And he's certainly charged on the football a couple of times on that occasion. And his young blokes have been working off him. Rosier again was terrific. In his 50th game.
32 minutes first quarter, approaching 31 in the second quarter. Timekeeper's getting paid by the hour today.
As Clay Beams, he's done it an awful lot this quarter, wins himself centre clearance. And he is just magnificent by foot, Clay Beams. He's just spotted up Callum Bartlett absolutely perfectly there. So Bartlett wins, spins around on the left. He just kicks it up there. Lyle's going to have the run at it. Couldn't quite get there. Clark's got pushed, smacked into the turf. But the Lions are in a dangerous scoring position here. In a remarkable game of swinging fortunes. Mm. It's back to 13 points. It was 29 not long ago. But the Lions are in a scoring position. Cornelius gives it to that man, Beams again.
Great tackle.
But the tackle, it could be on here.
Yeah, Kenrick Tyrrell just affecting the path of the football with his kick as well, as the man in the track pants makes an appearance. We can see the emergency umpire running out now. We never like the appearance of the man in the track pants, so you can just deliver your message and then hightail it pretty quickly as Matt Rosier is going to take the free kick for the Thunder.
Yeah, nothing in that. So Rosier's just going to come out, overshoots Rowe. Dunn's in best position to mark, and a good mark by Dunn. Playing a long way away from the goals. Playing more of a utility role today.
Lions coach Nathan Clark not happy with Billy Longa that time. Not good enough was the big word that came from the bench.
So the siren sounded for half time on what has been a really seesawing game of football that sees the Brisbane Lions ahead 10-7-67 to 8-6-54. It was another 32-minute quarter, and just when we thought the NT Thunder were really, really struggling, they managed to kick three quick goals, and we've got ourselves a real contest again.
They have indeed. Goal kickers for the game so far for the Lions, two each to Jordan Lyle and Jack Fox. Singles to Hawksley, Beams, Stiller, Buchanan, Cornelius and Crisp. For the Thunder, three goals to Darren Ewing, two each to Farrah and Austin Wanamiri, and one in the first quarter to Patrick Heenan.
Well, I think the key here for the Thunder is that they're going to have the A team out there for as long as they can, and yep, they're going to rely heavily on the fitness of the likes of Dignan and Islet and Rosier in particular, and the big man Tyrrell. They're going to just have to throw all caution
to the wind. Do what they did in the last stage of the quarter then. If Cameron Islet needs a rest, rest him in the forward line, not on the bench. Keep him on the ground.
It's going to be a big ask against a team of semi-professionals against a professional team, but those guys have been terrific when they've been on the ball, and so much is just going to come down to them.
Fantastic second half of the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final coming up. 13-point lead to the Brisbane Lions, but the Thunder doing all of the attacking in the late stages of the quarter. We're going to come back with all of the second half action in what's going to be a ripping game of football right after this on Thunder Vision.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the halftime break here today. We've got some awesome stuff here today for the half-time break. We've got some NAB Auskick games happening, and we also have our AFL 9s feature game in the middle of the oval here. We've got the Drop Bears, which is the black and pink team, and then we also have the Tigers, which are in the Cadbury Dream Team jerseys. Ladies and gentlemen, yes, you can see that we do have all the players out here as well, getting all pumped and excited for the 100 metre sprint, the feature race. And you can see Sonny Ray and Bernie Gavavegas trying to pump the boys up as well. And we've also got Cracker here as well. He's here, he's in the race, and he's pumped and excited. Ladies and gentlemen, I've also just heard that Sonny Ray and also Bernie Gavavegas are going to participate into the sprint as well. It's going to be very interesting. A little bit of comedic relief against the boys who will actually be super lightning fast. Introduction of the races here today, ladies and gentlemen. From Southport, we have Daniel Vanderwerken. He was an under-18s Queensland Scorpions representative this year, and he's got pace to burn. He's the Flying Dutchman, Daniel Vanderwerken. From Mount Gravatt, we have Ben Daly. He's a wingman. He's a former 400-metre national representative. He does this kind of stuff daily, ladies and gentlemen. Ben Daly. From Morningside, we have Chris Hunt. He's a centre-half back. He's going to hunt down the competition today. Let's see how it goes. From Morningside, Chris Hunt. From Labrador, we have Dustin Mills. He is a pacey defender. He's moving to Cairns very shortly so he can become a doctor of all things. So let's see him carve it up here. The doctor, Dustin Mills. From Broadbeach, we have Callum Geary, who is the NEAFL Rising Star nomination in round 7 this year. In 2009 at the AFL Draft Camp, he got a 9.43 in the 3-kilometre time trial. He's geared up for it today, Callum Geary. From Redland, we have Zane Pringle. The 20-year-old represented the under-18s Queensland Scorpions in 2010. This part-time model will strut his stuff here today, Zane Pringle. From Astley, we have Jack Stanley. This 22-year-old was a member of the Gold Coast Suns inaugural season. He represented the under-18 Scorpions in 2009. Let's see him sting from the Asquith Hornets, Jack Stanley. We also have, from the NT, you can see him, we've got Cracker lining up, looking up in the heavens. He's loving life. Let's see a little bit of thunder and a little bit of lightning from Cracker. From the Lions, we also have Reese Power. He was in the under-18 2012 Queensland Scorpions rep team from the Lions Academy. Will he answer the call from the Lions? Brisbane Lions, Reese Power, well done there, champ. And as I stated before, we also have Sonny Ray lining up, getting the high knees. He's got the red hair, he's got the goggles on.
Let's see how he goes. Sunny Ray from the Gold Coast Suns. And rounding out the field, he's looking like he's from Bris Vegas, because he is. We've got Bernie Gabba Vegas. The boys are lining up. Ladies and gentlemen, it would be fantastic if we could get the Usain Bolt clap happening. Just because I stop doesn't mean you have to. Just a reminder as well, ladies and gentlemen, that the winner of the sprint will win $250. We have a big check right at the finishing line for them. That's an incentive right there, $250. They're off their racing. This is looking fantastic. How are we going here? Very fast indeed. All the way. I believe he's got it. The Flying Dutchman, Daniel Vanderwerken. He's working hard. Daniel Vanderwerken. Congratulations, mate. You've won $250. Well done. And ready out the field, Bernie Gabba Vegas coming in last. Bad luck there, champion. Fantastic to see. Congratulations to Daniel Vanderwerken. Well done. The Flying Dutchman wins himself some coin. Congratulations to Daniel Vanderwerken. Vanders, if you can come over to me, champion, congratulations. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the Flying Dutchman, Daniel Vanderwerken. Congratulations there, champion. Hold up so everyone can see. Look at that. Oh, beautiful stuff. Well done. Big smiles and shake your hands. Well done, champion. Good work, buddy. The winner of the 2012 halftime sprint, Daniel Vanderwerken from Southport. Congratulations there, Daniel. Ladies and gentlemen, it is also time for the raffle. We have the winner of tickets to the AFL Grand Final for this year. Get your tickets out, ladies and gentlemen. The winner of the 2012 Toyota AFL Grand Final ticket draw is ticket number 341. Congratulations, you have won yourself some tickets to the AFL Grand Final. Head on over to the centre wing and come and see Greg Howe for your tickets. Congratulations to ticket number 341. There's a ripping goal right there in the AFL Nines game to the Tigers. Well done there. Pats on the back all round. Well done. Got an interchange happening right now for the drop airs. Fantastic to see. ladies and gentlemen, have a good look at the NAB AFL Oz Kickers having a go here. It is fantastic to see. They are the future of the game, and they are carving it up today. Very, very, very exciting for the young boys and girls. Congratulations to the NAB AFL Oz Kickers for today. AFL Nines is a competition that everybody can join. Doesn't matter if you're old, if you're young, if you're male, if you're female, everybody can join AFL Nines. So make sure you guys check it out because it's heaps of fun, and as you can see, these guys are having an absolute crack of it today. Beautiful mark there by the big fella from the drop bears. Well done there, champion. From the Tigers, well done there, champ. Gentlemen, that the winning ticket for the grand final draw was ticket number 341. You still have not come to claim your prize. You have got 1 minute to go and see Greg to win your tickets. Otherwise, we'll have to redraw it or I'll have to take it. And you don't want that, so hurry up if your ticket number 341. Ladies and gentlemen, if you can put your hands together for the NAB AFL Oz Kickers and the AFL Nines representatives. Fantastic stuff to see. Congratulations, guys. Great effort. And tick-tock says the clock. That has been a minute. Well, that means it's a redraw. If you had ticket number 341, bad luck. Skip Mickey's. It's time for a newie. Okay, everyone, get your tickets back out. And... oh, here we go. The new winner of the 2012 Toyota AFL Grand Final ticket draw is ticket number 49. 49. Look at that. As he legit won it. If he didn't throw it away, he's won it. As he got two tickets to paradise. He's got it. Congratulations. Well done, mate. Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the winner of the 2012 Toyota AFL Grand Final ticket draw. Well done there, champion. Ladies and gentlemen, that concludes the halftime entertainment. Thanks heaps for that, ladies and gentlemen. And let's get ready for the second half of the grand final here today.
Yeah, well done, Harley. Fantastic work out of our NAB Auskick halftime entertainment. Led there by Harley Hollins. So well done, Harley, for a great job there with the sprint, the NAB Auskick, and the AFL 9. Fantastic work. Okay, we're just about ready for resumption of the second half. Who's going to take this one out? Brisbane Lions, 13-point leaders at half time. Just a couple picking out.
Thank you for this great opportunity to build the ICTHIS LNG project in the Territory. That's why we're giving back to the community.
Students across Northern Australia now have access to more trade skills here in Darwin.
Oil and gas training and research are now available at our university because of this world-class project.
And more than 14 million has been injected into
Welcome
local roads.
We're committed to growing the Territory, so let's take this journey together.
ICTHIS, securing the future. Authorised by ICTHIS LNG Proprietary Limited Perth.
The Lions 10-7-67, leading the Thunder 8-6-54, 13-point lead to the Lions. It was out as far as 31 points in that second quarter, the Lions lead, after they trailed by 18 at three at quarter time, and then the last three goals of the quarter to the NT Thunder to drag it back to a much more manageable situation. Fantastic day on Thunder Vision at the moment. We've had over 1,700 viewers throughout the day so far, and we've seen that there is a huge crowd gathered at Kazali's in Palmerston to cheer on the NT Thunder. So make sure you get around Thunder Vision for this second half, because this is going to be a great, great grand final, and it's anyone's game at this stage, I can tell you that right now. Sean Kelly's my name, Ron McDonald's with me, and Ronnie, what are we going to expect in this second half? The Thunder kicking to the scoring end of the ground in this third quarter, and the breeze just seems to have picked up a little bit at half time.
Well, quite simply, the Thunder need to be in front at three-quarter time, Sean, and they need to be in far as front as they possibly can. I mean, they have that three-goal advantage at quarter time, and we thought that was going to be pretty useful, but when the Lions kicked those eight consecutive goals, it put a completely different slant on the game. Look, you'd think that they'd need to be somewhere between two and three goals in front to give themselves some sort of a chance, so that means they're going to have to win this quarter by five goals, and that's a lot to ask against a Brisbane Lions team that's been particularly impressive all year. And look, when you look at the lineup and some of the names in the Brisbane Lions team, when you go back to the last Lions Reserves Grand Final team was in 2000.
Talk us through some of those names, because there's some big, big names.
Well, that's it. There was Des Headland, who the next year went on and finished fifth in the Brownlow medal. There was Craig Bolton, who went on to be a two-time All-Australian defender. There was Jamie Charman, a premiership ruckman. There was Richard Hadley and Ashmore McGrath.
Brisbane Lions Richard Hadley too.
Premiership players. There was Joel McDonald, who's now playing at Melbourne. There was Aaron Shattuck, who played in a premiership team. And the likes of Shane Morrison and Dylan McLaren and Damien Cupido and Luke Weller, who all played senior football. So if history's any guide, then several players from this Brisbane Lions team will go on and make very, very big marks in the AFL scene in the years to come. So that's what the Thunder are up against. The bounce down to start this third quarter. It's Tyrrell against Longa. Tyrrell read it much better. Put it down the throat of Islet, but he was tackled, slung. This is Dignan who's going to run onto the ball, but Eamon Buchanan, who's been at the...
Great tackle.
...packs. Ball spills out here to Rosie. A great tackle by Cameron Islet. Ball over
the back there's Jed Anderson. Umpire's found himself a free kick.
It was a downfield free. Cameron Eilert got taken down after he got rid of
the
ball.
Well, that's good to see the umpires have done that, because there was a couple of late, very, very heavy shoves in that second quarter that a couple of players didn't get very happy about. So the umpires have obviously discussed that at halftime, and they'll be hot on that in this third quarter. Farrah's going to fly from the back. Didn't get the big leap one might have expected. It's Argus at ground level. Knocks the ball out towards the boundary line. Wrapped up in a tackle there. Fierce tackle there. Looks like by Elliot Yeo has put on one of the Thunder players on Matty Argus. Up they both get.
And
get
the starting midfield for the Thunder in this quarter. Eilert, Dignan, Rosier.
Yeah, it's the A-team. That's what they're going to have to rely on. We spoke about that at halftime as Eilert runs onto it again. The man who's inspired the team on so many occasions is going to need to inspire them again. The 2011 Grogan medalist, Cameron Eilert.
And the runner-up in 2012, one of three runners-up after there were three winners as well in Matty Rosier.
Matty Rosier, correct weight. But that is the man they're going to have to stop. Just talking to several people there at halftime, they thought Clay Beams had certainly been the Brisbane Lions' best player and was in the running for the Joe Grant medal. While there were a lot of Thunder people very happy Jason Rowe was out there, they thought he was miles ahead of the rest.
Yep, well and truly. So the Lions with the ball of half-back, just moving it forward with shorts. Now up to centre wing. Good work by the Thunder, just affected the spall that time and knocks it out of bounds, Ronnie.
And I don't know what happened, but Billy Longa is doubled up on centre wing there. He's just getting up now. Looks like he's either been very, very heavily winded or hit somewhere where you really don't want to be hit. But he gets up, okay, he gets up for the ruck knock, okay, but down on the haunches again after having won it. But as the Lions go forward, there's that man, Jason Rowe, picks it up. Could have been pushed in the back, no free kick forthcoming. Rosier picks it up at ground level for his second possession early in this third quarter. Goes down there looking for Vassal. Little knock over the back, didn't go to Argus, which was where he wanted. Yo, that's good composure. Dishes it back off to a teammate there at back, but he's wrapped up. That's going to be holding the ball. Umpire says play it on. Wanamiri gets it, gives it off towards Rosier. Rosier's in position. Oh, super tackle there by the Lions player there, and Eamon Buchanan. He's certainly working his way up the Brisbane Lions' best player list, and gives it to Justin Clark, the full back, but it's come off the side of the boot in front of the big sign out there at Leishen Park, and we'll get ourselves the Thunder kicking the ball back in through Tyrrell.
We will indeed. Big Kenrick Tyrrell. He's probably been in the best half dozen for the Thunder so far. In fact, it's not going to be him that brings the kick in, but he's going to be the recipient of it. So Kenrick Tyrrell moves the ball across, finds Tapp at centre half back. He's got some space to work in. Tapp goes straight down the middle of the ground. Lockwood's going to fly at the back. Couldn't quite take the mark. Need the crummers. Don't get them. Lions have got it through Cummins. Cummins with the 50-metre kick. 25 up and 25 down. Not really to advantage of anyone. Rosier picks it up at the back of the pack. Wanted the handball instead. Just turns the corner. Now Rowe. Wanted a handball as well to Rusker. In the end, decided against it. Went the other way. Long inside the forward line in the Wanamiri direction. Ewing was there as well. Brings the football to ground level. Over it this time is Vassal. Trees gives a little feed out. Kick around the corner. Ewing just couldn't quite mark it. Through four. One behind. Had to sit on it. Just couldn't get it in the Dukes at the crucial moment, Darren Ewing. And it is the Northern Territory Thunder getting the first score of this quarter. Moving to 8-7-55. The Lions 10-7-60. 4 minutes, third quarter.
Well, that was a strange kick in by the Lions as Cameron Eilert loads up from way outside 50, but doesn't quite hit the mark, and it's another minor score to the Thunder. Good to see Eilert and Rosie are getting their hands on the ball early in this third quarter. We just hit 4 minutes, and the margin's been reduced to an even 2 goals in favour of the Brisbane Lions reserves, with the Thunder doing all the early attacking. This looks like Shaney Stiller. Skipper going to bring the ball in for the Lions reserves. Nothing to go to, so just kicks it hard and high. Tap in best position to mark. Never looked like he wasn't going to take that, Sean Tap.
Lyle led towards the boundary, but the kick didn't go that way, and Lyle didn't really come back hard enough to affect a spoil on Tap.
And that was an inch-perfect kick there by Tap, too. He didn't have a lot to go to. He saw the only space was there in the pocket, and that the way was Heenan was running. Dignan thought the ball was coming his way, but it overshot him, and it landed beautifully in the arms of Heenan. The only problem is he's got a very, very tight angle here. Right in front of the QAFL officers, or the old AFLQ officers, and he's kicked it to the near side, and it's another minor score to the Thunder, who have advanced their score by 3 behinds this quarter and reduced the margin to 11 points. They've got runners on here this time, the Lions. This goes to Justin Clark. Got the job on Ewing. Kept him goalless in that second quarter. Was looking for Dyson. Good mark by Josh Dyson. Plays on straight away. Gets onto the left foot. Overshoots Beam, but it hits the mark there. It looks like Fox. Fox, he's got Scott Clark running for him. That's the way the ball goes, but Rowe reads it magnificently. Gets his hand to the football, butters up again. He's going to shoot out the handball there, looking for Rioli. Good tackle by young Fox. Done some very hard work down there in the forward pocket as young Fox from the Western Magpies.
He's been very good today, Jack.
And speaking of the Western Magpies, all credit to Nathan Clark, the coach of the Brisbane Lions reserves. He's worked that whole relationship with the Western Magpies really well for two seasons now and got just reward for getting his team into the grand final. As Lyle runs onto it, he's put it in front of Cornelius. Great work from behind there by Williams, but it doesn't help as that looks like Hawksley runs onto it, and Hawksley's kicked a magnificent goal out of nothing. Super work by James Hawksley, and that is a goal against the run of the play by the Brisbane Lions. Very, very handy one for them. They move to 11-7-73. The Thunder are 8-9-57, and that's a bit of a heartbreaker, Sean.
Certainly is. James Hawksley's second goal of the game, and just one of those ones where the football fell beautifully for him. The Thunder thought that when the ball bounced off Aaron Cornelius's chest that they were a chance, but just fell into the path nicely for Hawksley and gets one after the Thunder had done all of the early attacking. It just means that the Thunder have got to double their efforts to try and get back in front in this game. So the ball back in the centre of the ground. Longa looks okay in the ruck. It's up against the high flyer in Verncombe that time, but he got the tap down easily. Working it forward and a nice mark at centre-half forward by Scott Clark. So Clark sits one up in the Cornelius direction. Just got rid of his opponent, couldn't quite take the mark at ground level. Around the ball, Thunder have got the numbers, trying to run it out of the back line now. They do well through Rioli. Takes a couple on, has a bounce. Football behaves drunkenly, doesn't quite come back to him. Could have got one in the back. Umpire says no. Karnezes is going to go forward. Cornelius front position, couldn't drag it down again. Good work by the Lions, by the Thunder, sorry. Just to get out of trouble, and Rioli takes the mark. They're away off half-back of the Thunder. Long kick down centre wing. Too high for Lockwood. Charging out this time. Good work over the top that time. The Thunder just bad handball in the end. Lions have got the numbers. They run forward in waves. This is crisp. Kicked a goal in the first quarter. Gives it over. Karnezes inside forward 50. Leading man was for the Lions that time. Gave away the free kick. It was Cornelius, I think, on the lead. He's given away the free kick and 50 metres, I believe.
And Ben Rioli deserves that. He put his body on the line in the last contest 30 seconds ago. Didn't get a free kick when he should have done. And now he's put his body on the line again. So he's going to have a nice sore back tonight.
Stood on the tracks when the train was running through and justly rewarded for it was Ben Rioli, who's lifted in this quarter noticeably.
It won't hurt if they win themselves another premiership medallion.
Certainly won't, as Rioli finds his man.
It's Jack Lawler.
So Lawler,
very prominent in the last foray.
The ball on half forward goes in the direction of Farrah, who got high, couldn't bring the mark down though. Wanamiri got a touch, but it's at ground level. Doherty can run it out for the Lions. Gives a little handball to Hawksley. Now they can go back. Good running play by the Lions. Just couldn't quite take the mark that time. Did well to keep it alive. Hawksley called for it in the middle. Instead, they go backwards. High up and under kick. Clark just bumps his opponent under the football. Now they can go inside 450. They're bringing the football back, are they? It's going to call a free kick against Clark. I didn't think there was too much wrong with that, actually.
I was watching off the ball. There was some little bit going on in the centre there. Williams could have caught himself a free kick for high contact, but I was obviously the only one who saw that, Sean.
So it's Shannon Ruska has the football. Gives over to Dignan. Dignan wants Matty Argus, who's on a long lead.
That's probably just a reflection of the run of the respective teams at the moment, Sean. I mean, that was a really tough one-on-one contest. He had Cummins right on his hammer there, Argus, whereas when the Lions are moving forward, they've got men running and breaking left, right and centre. Looks like Tapp may have gone into the ruck there for the moment. Big punch forward. That's only going to go to the advantage of the Lions because they've got the numbers back. This is Dyson. He hasn't got a lot forward, so he just kicks and hopes. Beams there. He can't grab it, and there's Rowe again with another defensive effort. Gee, his one percenters have been special today. He's been winning the ball, he's been doing everything.
Certainly has. It's been great. He's been the Thunder's best player, as we mentioned, far and away.
So it's Sam Michael will be in the ruck up against Viencombe. Michael takes the front position, puts it to the advantage of Buchanan. He can't get a handle on it. This is Dignan. He falls on the ball, wrapped up by Beams. That's not going to come out in a hurry, and we'll get ourselves another ball up. Goal, a 16-point advantage here to the Brisbane Lions reserves. The Thunder really need to get a wiggle on.
Lions kick the only goal of the quarter through James Hawksley.
Viencombe over the top. It's roved by Dyson. That left footed kick is only going to go into the crowd, and we see one of the bigger build-ups of the crowd there at half forward, one of the elevated positions here at Yeronga, which is still it was remodeled 2 years ago. It was formerly just a lower division club for the Yeronga Football Club. It's a proud history, the Yeronga Footy Club, been around since the 1890s. But the ground's certainly in much better condition than it used to be, as McEwen gets a handball looking for Lawler. Lawler just taps it to the advantage of a teammate, but it doesn't go that way. Here's that man Beams again. Fix it all over towards Cornelius. Cornelius gives it to Hawksley. Hawksley gives another handball. That's great running football, Brisbane Lions. Jordan Lyle kicks the goal. And the man in the centre holding his head there, just trying to make him out, was the architect of that.
It was
Callum Bartlett. Thanks for that, Sean. Yeah, Callum Bartlett, take a bow. That was great football there. He's taken a fairly heavy knock to the face, but he'll wear it because his team's just taken a four-goal break. They're 12-7-79, leading the Thunder 8-9-57. We're almost 11 minutes into this third quarter, and we're coming to a critical time again, Sean. The breeze does feel like it's dropped a little, but they really do need to make the most of everything they can here at the moment, the Thunder, and it looks like they've shuffled up the midfield there. Vassal's gone into it with Lawler. As Tyrrell wins the knock, but Buchanan's going to run onto it again. They're full of run, the Lions. They're looking very, very sharp. This is Scott Clark, who's been very impressive there across half-forward. Marks it in front of Rowe. He's got Bartlett on the lead. He likes to go wider for Conway. Bartlett's going to run onto it, but he's going to get knocked out over the boundary line.
Wasn't the greatest kick in the world that time by Scotty Clark, and the football over the boundary line. Some of the players asking for out of bounds on the full, which was probably a little bit of a seed there because it appeared to have come off the foot of one of the Lions players. However, it's Tiggy Touchwood, and the ball's thrown back in. Kenrick Tyrrell got the tap. Good work, Wanamiri. Handball back to Vassal. Bouncing football, almost evaded the man in Nye McKeever. In fact, it does in the end. He's got three to beat. Just casts one aside. Now here's Cam Islett. Islett on the right foot, in towards the hot spot, back of the pack, Ewing just got rid of Clark, now needs to run onto it. Good work by the Lions though, that was Jesse Wallen, just got in at the right time, but Paddy Heenan almost took the football into a goal and instead just lost it at the crucial moment, and it goes over the boundary line for a throw in about 20 metres around from the Thunder's goal.
Yeah, things just aren't quite falling into place for the Thunder there when they go forward, the ball's not quite bouncing their way.
So it's thrown back in, it's Lockwood against Michael. Lockwood got the tap in the front spot. A lot of players around the football lines, getting a lot of numbers back to help out defensively, and the football goes over the boundary line once again for another boundary throw in.
Well, they're building the wall across half forward there, the Thunder, if the ball does come out. Tyrrell's just freeing up Matty Argus there now. Rose moving down.
It's thrown back in. Lockwood, again the tap, but it's Sharks. Buchanan did nicely, got a handball out. Dangerous though, nice little flick by Crisp. Now Doherty can run, gives a little handball. Bouncing football, Dyson takes one bounce, goes towards Cornelius, just drops the mark at the crucial moment. Williams comes in, does nicely, little handball to Vassal. Vassal's got players on the spread on half forward. One of them's Heenan, who takes a nice mark. He's 55 out, goes to play on to Paddy Heenan, can deliver towards the goal square. Wanamiri's on his own, read it almost nicely. Well done by the Lions defenders to get back, just creating some space and seeing the ball over the boundary line. Yes, they are, for another boundary throw in.
Well, Damien Williams should take a bow. The Lions were on there, and he's done a really, really good job against Cornelius. We spoke earlier in the game that about how Cornelius had the strength and the advantage, but Williams has done really, really well and none better on that last occasion and set up a scoring opportunity here for the Thunder as Vassal takes it out off the clearance and puts it right on the chest of Julian Lockwood, who will shoot for goal from 30 metres out, and to say that the Thunder need this would be an understatement.
It is indeed. Julian Lockwood almost directly in front, and another stoppage resulting in a shot for goal. It's been uncanny how many of those we've seen today, and it's really been the key. Whoever's getting the advantage in the midfield in this game, as Austin Wanamiri comes off the ground for the Thunder. So Julian Lockwood, yet to goal today. He's going to shoot this from about 35 metres out, no real angle to speak of. Starts it right, stays right. Kick did not look great at all off the boot, and it's through for one behind. 8-10-58, that makes the NT Thunder. The Lions are 12-7-79. It's 21-point lead to the boys from Brisbane Town. 14 and a half minutes, third quarter. The Lions bring the football back in. Move it up towards our broadcast side wing. Just overshot the man in Lyle that time. The ball goes over for another boundary throw-in. So no problems with vantage spot here. This is right in front of our commentary spot. It's thrown in. Good tap by Tyrrell, then gets the second effort, does nicely to kick the ball inside forward 50. One on two, the one was Lockwood and he did okay, just couldn't hold on to it at the crucial moment. Anderson went in hard but couldn't take the footy with him. Wade and Numbers wins out for the Lions as Billy Longer across half back kicks towards a two on two contest. Back of the pack, Williams did nicely for the Thunder, high up and under kick towards half forward. Buchanan put himself under the footy but couldn't hold on to it. Good work by Yo, just gets dispossessed at the last moment. Heenan brings him down and he's going to get the free kick. I reckon that was a pretty hot one. I didn't really see that.
No, I'm with the umpire. I'm with the umpire on that one. I thought he got it 100% right. Had an opportunity, elected to take it over the line, dropped the football. Good tackle, Paddy Heenan.
Heenan, long kick inside forward 52 on one. Front of the pack, Ewing's got it at ground level now. Throws a kick around the corner. It was Willie Farrow that couldn't take the mark that time, and Ewing's kick couldn't find any touch at all over the boundary line on the full.
That's four behinds and one out of bounds on the full from five scoring attempts this quarter in the first half of the third quarter by the Thunder. The Lions have had two scoring shots and kicked the only two goals of the quarter.
So the Lions bring the ball back in. Long as the target. Tyrrell's there at the back of the pack as well. Neither could mark. Rosier at ground level. Just tried to outpoint Karnezes. Karnezes got the sling on him at the right moment. Tried to find Wallen. Thunder keep the ball back in but just shuffle it out at the last moment. It was Brad Vassell on hands and knees and the ball's going to be thrown in 50 metres around from the Thunder goal. Ronnie McDonald.
Yeah, again, a lot of players around the ball as we've seen at this scoring in. Both ruckman wrestle. Will Tyrrell get himself a free kick?
Going the other way.
The umpires said that Longer was being held. Tyrrell shakes his head. Ball's been given to Doherty. He goes back to Karnesis. Always has plenty of time in the world, this man. Looks for Scott Clark, who's worked really hard, but the ball's gone out of bounds on the full.
Actually thought he was looking for Callum Bartlett, who's standing here in front of us on the wrong side of the boundary.
So Williams, who's done a really good job on Cornelius, going to bring the ball back in.
We questioned that matchup earlier, right, Ronnie, but Damian Williams has got the better of it. Aaron Cornelius has only kicked one goal in the game so far.
So Williams has gone long looking for Tyrrell. Can't mark. Lockwood got himself in there. Dignan's at ground level. He hasn't got a lot on. He has to give it to Argus. Argus waits for him to run back in bounds. Onto the left foot, Dignan. He's got two on short, but he elected to go long. Argus ain't going to have the height advantage, but it comes down to Vassell. He'll swing onto the left foot. He's got a man wide. He had two wide. One of them was Anderson, but it overshoots him. Umpire's found himself a free kick for holding. It's going to go against Justin Clark. Clark, who held Ewing to just a solitary goal the last time these two teams played, conceded three in the opening quarter of this game, but he's tightened right up. Nonetheless, Buff Ewing has three goals, one to his name, and the Thunder desperately need it to be four. On that trusty left foot, he's only going to shoot from 30 metres out. Angle shouldn't be in too much of a problem.
Eilert back on the ground for the Thunder.
Oh, give a bloke a rap. He's missed that. That's a bad one for the Thunder. They really, really needed that. He's kicked it across the face of goal for the minus score. So that's five behinds and an out of bounds on the full. And they're kicking themselves out of this very quickly, Sean.
Reminiscent of the preliminary final last week, Craig Miller, the NEAFL operations manager, in special comments. Every time he wraps someone up in front of goal, guaranteed to miss. So the football comes back into play. Lions go with the long kick. They went for the tall targets in Lyle and Longer. Lyle did well to rove it. Gets the football around the corner into a man with some space. Then gets the 1-2 back. Great work by Tapp to run him down, though. Still got the possession away. Conway, underground handball, headed for the boundary line. Found it, and it will be a boundary throw-in. Well, the Thunder players that time, Williams and Rosier, wanted deliberate. It was a nice little smart underground handball from Conway to find the boundary line. So it's thrown back in. Karnezes gets a tap. Dignan had his kick smothered. Beams does well. Had Buchanan in support. Lyle's also there. The three of them link up. Now another handball chain comes out. Fox just got rid of it. Tried to parlay the ball in front of him. Does okay. Karnezes comes in for support and gets the football. Inside forward 50 again. Nice mark. Umpire said no, not 15 metres. Thunder players get around it. It's going to be an over-the-shoulder free kick. Williams just a little overzealous with the tackle. And the Lions are going to take a free one inside their own forward half. And it's going to be Dave Cummins, is it, with the free kick? No, it's not. It is Isaac Conway, the boy from the Aspley Football Club, who's going to, you'd like to say, have a shot, but he's on a really, really tough angle, Ronnie.
Very clever work there by young Jack Fox there. Mm. There he was surrounded by opponents, so he's just tunnel-balled the ball, and it's gone out the back to Karnesis, which set up this shot at goal.
So Conway, check side kick around the corner. Right idea, just didn't quite have the right accuracy on it and misses to the left-hand side. Lions 12-8-80, Thunder 8-11-59, approaching the 20-minute mark of this third quarter in the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final.
Well, looking to go from last to first, the Brisbane Lions reserves. Last in 2011, and they've now got a very handy 21-point advantage, shooting for their second ever QAFL NEAFL Premiership. That kick goes long, but it's into a nest of Lions again. Great work there by Vin. Come charges through the pack. He's got an outrider here in Anderson. He's going to have to fly high. Oh, he's just gone a fraction of a section too early, giving away the free kick. Umpire calls pay on. Conway's got it again. He's gone out there looking for Dyson. Dyson's given the Lions an enormous amount of run this quarter.
He's
been very, very important to them. Josh Dyson on the left foot. Played a couple of games of senior footy. He's got Lyle short. That's the way he opts to go. Rioli's not going to get there. Jordan Lyle. Look, there's not a lot of on offer, so he's just going to have to kick it long to the goal square. No, he says, come out there. I'm going to chop it up there for Cornelius. Tap comes across, and as he's done so many times, spoils the football. Sean Tapp playing something of a home game. Grew up in the western suburbs of Brisbane. Played for the Fernie Grove Junior Football Club. The mighty Falcons out there in the northwestern suburbs. It comes down to Cameron Islet. This is Bartlett on the left foot, screws it around the body. That's not to come around far enough. And we're going to get a free kick in for Jason Rowe, who will line up for what must be possession 20 or 25.
It'd have to be well and truly that.
He goes the switch across there looking for Tap. Tap's going to let it bounce. He's got Conway bearing down on him. Bounces nicely for Tap. Assesses the situation. Goes down there looking for Farrah. Farrah was under the pump. Needed the ball to bounce for Heenan, and it didn't go that way. So this is Conway who's got it now. Gives it to Crisp. Oh, he's got Hawksley loose. Hawksley, who was particularly prominent in that second quarter, has got Lyle, who keeps on finding space. And Lyle's going to have himself a shot at goal.
He's kicked three already. Thunder kicked all of their goals after the 27-minute mark in the second quarter. Don't think the quarter's going to really have that much legs in it. There's only been two goals kicked. We've played almost 22 minutes. They're going to have to get their move on if they want to do the same thing again.
And big Jordan Lyle has been a terrific contributor since quarter time. Certainly he lowered his colours to Sean Tapp. The coaching staff made the move to give him more of a free running role. And he has certainly been an important factor for the Brisbane Lions reserves. We know he can kick a goal. Former Hawthorn player. Kicks it long and high. The goal umpire doesn't have to make too
nice
much
kick.
And that might well be the goal that broke the Camel's back. They've now got effectively a 5-goal lead. It's 27 points. It's 13-8 plays 8-11. We're 22 minutes into the third quarter, and now the Thunder again, as we said about this stage of the second quarter, Sean, have got it all before them.
We certainly did, Ronnie, as Lyle kicks his fourth goal for the game. He's second in this quarter. You mentioned he didn't have the great run of it in the first quarter, but a couple of little things fell his way early in the second quarter. He's created his own confidence out of that. He's now kicked 4 goals, and he's been one of the real talisman for the Lions today, as Longa favoured with the bounce, gets the tap straight down, beams, gave over the top, was going to get it back on the 1-2, but the Lions instead go the other way. They can just do whatever they please at the moment, it seems, the Lions. Bartlett may have been held off the football, going to get it on the turnaround from Dyson, can turn and go inside 50, nice little pass. Cornelius tried to put the one hand out Kudafidi style, didn't stick. Williams did okay, ran into his own teammate in row though, had to give the football up, tackled his Islet too high, free kick. And to go the way of the Thunder, in fact it's not Islet at all, it's Brad Vassell.
They've got all the run again at the moment, the Brisbane Lions reserves,
yeah.
And we know that they're going to run out the game strongly.
Thunder just, you're right, haven't got that run at the moment. Vassell tried to go down the line, but that's how the quarter's gone so far. Just hooked it, came off the side of the boot, out of bounds on the full, free possession to the Lions. Callum Bartlett looks like he's going to take the free kick.
There's just no imagination there from the Thunder at the moment. Poor old Williams there actually tried to take the game on, and all he did was run into to a teammate who happened to put himself in the way.
Buchanan straight onto the ground, gets a possession, gives back to Bartlett, can go inside forward 50. Cornelius went with the one hand, will get a free against him. Going to be Jason Rowe's free kick. So Rowe.
Lucky he's been out there, Sean.
Oh, yeah. It would be desperately bad if he wasn't there, as Rowe sizes up his options, finds Vassell. So that name a fair bit in this third quarter, Brad Vassell. Definitely hasn't stopped trying all day. Kick's not great, though. Goes to Stiller.
Men on the switch here if they want it. They got loose men everywhere.
Instead, they go straight down the line, and the mark's taken 45 metres from goal. The kick's going to be from 50. And the Lions are just falling into place for them nicely, Ronnie McDonald.
And it's that man, Josh Dyson, again, yep. who has had a massive third quarter. They call it the premiership quarter. And he's
could
really
hold
stood up. He has really stood up as Josh Dyson. Very good running player, very good skills. Wasn't bad early, but he's certainly risen to prominence in this third quarter. He must have had 10 or 12 touches already.
Dyson runs into kick, crosses the 50 now. He's going to go from 47. No real angle to speak of. Goal umpire did not move. First goal for the day for Josh Dyson. Lions fourth for the quarter. They're on fire, the Brisbane Lions. They're 14-8, which is 92. The NT Thunder 8-11, which is 59. 25 minutes gone in this third quarter. You mentioned the premiership quarter. The Lions, I reckon, at the moment have got one hand on the cup, Ronnie McDonald.
Yeah, look, it's starting to bear remarkable similarities to the 2011 grand final, Sean, when the Thunder played against Morningside. Yes, the boots on the other foot. Remember that Morningside were very brave and game and played some exceptional football in the first half, but they trailed at halftime a little bit. The Thunder got themselves out to about a 5-goal break at three-quarter time and then kicked 11 goals in a remarkable final quarter to have that massive victory, kick 26 goals for the day. Not saying that the Lions are going to kick 11 to finish it, but all the signs are very, very pessimistic for the Thunder as we look at Hawksley getting the ball on the wing. Good run there by Crisp. He's given it to Clark. He's been terrific. This is Yo on the half-back flank. Sorry, it's weird, and he just gives it up there to that man in Cummins. He goes into the centre. Got the man in Hawksley. He's just knocked up getting possessions other than kicking it in the
so
back of the Irishman.
Keep his back.
This must be an Irish joke. This is Lockwood. He's smothered there by Big Longa. That's everything's going the Lions' way now. Cummins knocks up. That wasn't a great handball, but clever work by Crisp over to Buchanan, who's
great
been
kick.
Very, very good. Strong hands by Beams. He's a magnificent user of the football. That is a magnificent kick of the football by Clay Beams, and he has putting his name firmly in the sights of those voting on the Joe Grant medal. The Lions players have rushed to him. They may well think that they now have one and a half hands on the cup, if that's completely possible, Sean.
Great work that time by Amon Buchanan. He was the beneficiary of some nice work from the tap, but his kick to Beams was just, to use a Dennis Kermetti phrase, absolutely centimetre perfect, and Beams just able to turn and kick on that right foot, as we've seen a couple of times today. Beautiful work by the Lions. They are all over this one. So it is the Lions 15-8, the Thunder 8-11, dying stages of the third quarter. All five goals in this quarter have gone to the Brisbane Lions. It is Jake Dignan that gets the clearance for the Thunder, though. Anderson just let himself underneath the football. Lions have got the numbers back defensively. Cummins gives a little chip over the top. Here they come again. Callum Bartlett, he's been good in this quarter as well. Kicks inside forward 50. Leading man's Cornelius. Couldn't mark. Might have got one in the back. Umpire says no. Thunder. Bad kick inside. Hawksley! Got high, James Hawksley. Great mark. Need to cap it off. Kick in the Fox direction. Rioli's down there as well. Did okay, but Fox has got the lead track on the football now. Can flick it over the top at the Duncan. Gets back for the Thunder. Can give a little handball out. Rioli tries to take him on. Does. Runs his full distance. Gets rid of the football by hand. Runs back onto it again. Rioli could have been taken without it. Umpire says no.
All credit to Rioli for trying to take the game on there, and it was very, very unlucky not to get the free kick. The Lions are going to mount up again. They've kicked 13 goals to 3 since quarter time, Sean. It's ominous looking for the Thunder.
And they have indeed, and the Lions look to come inside forward 50 again. A great tackle by the Thunder, though. Going to get the football across half-back. It is Argus, is it, across half-back? Just having a look.
No, it's Vassell again.
Now it is Brad Vassell. Thank you. So Vassell kicks towards half-forward. Just outpointed that time was Kenrick Terrell.
Sam Michael, great bodywork from the young man who's been was until this game arguably the Lions' best player at finals time.
Here's another one of them as they go deep inside forward 50, downfield free as well. Player was just bumped after the give from Buchanan that time in the middle of the ground. It's going to be a free kick to Aaron Cornelius. He's standing no more than 25 metres out from goal. In fact, it's going to be a 50-metre penalty as well. So he's going to line this one up from point-blank range. Damian Williams now jogging back onto the mark. Just says the umpire, what's the 50 metres
for? I'll tell you what, there's been a few of those 50-50 late bumps early on in the first half.
There has indeed, as Aaron Cornelius tries to kick that football into the city itself, kicks his second goal for the game. The beneficiary of some good work further upfield by the Lions, and this one is just about in the books. you'd think. The Lions are 16-8-104. The Thunder are 8-11-59. It's going to take something that would be an absolute club legendary moment if the Thunder were to get back into this one.
Yeah, and the Brisbane City Rowing Club have just scored themselves a Sharon by the looks of that. It's floating downstream somewhere towards the Eagle Street Pier at this stage. So they've had to bring themselves a new football in. Umpire Jason Baldwin just waits for the boundary umpire to set. There's 16-8 plays 8-11. It had that ominous look on the game in the second quarter before the Thunder kicked those late three goals.
And there's just that hush over the ground at the moment that makes you think that this game, everybody knows the situation the game's in at the moment, and it's the Thunder fans have just gone silent.
As Buchanan to Beams, and that's happened a fair bit on this game. Islet tries to take them on. Great tackle there by Big Sam Michael again. But the Thunder have got it down moving forward. Gee, they could do with a goal. Farrah runs onto it. He's crunched, but it spills to Ewing. Ewing's managed to dribble it through. That is the Thunder's first goal of the quarter, and they are really, really ruining those six misses in the first half of the quarter when they really could have got themselves back into the quarter. But good shooting at goals, good football, Sean. And unfortunately, it may well be all over by the shouting as there's still that seven goal deficit to have to overcome for the Thunder.
Certainly is. Patrick Ewing, good work, Sean. Darren Ewing's fourth goal of the game. Only one for the quarter in the Thunder so far. Gone past 30 minutes before the Thunder kicked their first of the game. First of the quarter. Bounce again.
Remarkably, they've kicked seven of their nine goals in time on of this game, the Thunder.
They have indeed, as the siren sounds. Three-quarter time in this grand final. The Lions seemingly with one hand on the Premiership Cup, but we know if ever there's a game where something special is going to happen, it's a grand final. And at three-quarter time, it is the Lions 16-8-104, leading the Thunder 9-11-65. Jordan Lyle has four goals for the Brisbane Lions, to each to Hawksley, Beams, and Aaron Cornelius and Jack Fox. Singles to Josh Dyson, Shaney Stiller, Amon Buchanan and Jack Crisp. For the Thunder, Darren Ewing has four, Farrah and Wanamiri two each, and one to Patrick Heenan. It's going to take something special for the Thunder. You can't see it happening. The Lions are getting better as the game goes on, and you think that just with the way they train and the professionalism that they're going to have the tanks to keep going in this last quarter. The Thunder will run the game out, but geez, it's a long mountain to climb from here.
When you've got Clay Beams and Eamon Buchanan in the form that they're in, and we spoke about it before the game.
They can't miss at the moment.
No, they are very sure with their ball handling. They're winning all the hard ball gets, and then it's not just those two. It's the fact that someone's stepping up every quarter. Josh Dyson's quarter was fantastic that quarter. We've got Jordan Lyle kicking goals for them. The Thunder defence is under siege, and like we say, we know that it's a professional football team. They train 7 days a week. They've won 12 of their last 13 fourth quarters, so it would take something more than a miracle for the Thunder to be able to get up from here.
Looks like the Lions might be headed south next week for the Cross Conference Grand Final in the NEAFL as well. They'll take on the winner of the Eastern Conference Grand Final between the Sydney Swans and Queanbeyan today, which I believe is at Marnica Oval in Canberra, and that's a big chance to be a curtain raiser. If the Swans win, it'll be the curtain raiser to the Sydney Collingwood preliminary final next week as well. But it's three quarter time here in the NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final. The Brisbane Lions seemingly 30 minutes away from their first NEAFL / QAFL premiership in 12 years. They lead at 16-8-104 to the Lions at 9-11-65. We'll be back after these messages with the final quarter on Thundervision.
Thank you for this great opportunity to build the ICTHIS LNG project in the Territory. That's why we're giving back to the community.
Students across Northern Australia now have access to more trade skills here in Darwin.
Oil and gas training and research are now available at our university because of this world-class project.
And more than 14 million has been injected into local roads.
We're committed to growing the Territory, so let's take this journey together.
ICTHIS, securing the future.
Authorised by ICTHIS LNG Proprietary Limited, Perth.
Palmerston Public Golf Course is a picturesque and challenging championship course. located just 16 minutes from Darwin CBD, at the very heart of Palmerston. The course features PGA qualified coaching and a fully equipped golf shop for all your golfing needs and custom club fittings. It's the perfect setting for a corporate day or a casual round, any day of the week. Palmerston Public Golf Course, at the very heart of Palmerston.
Just a reminder to all spectators, there will be a presentation on the field.
Welcome back to the final quarter of the 2012 NEAFL Grand Final here on Thunder Vision. It is the Brisbane Lions game to lose seemingly at this moment in time. The Lions 16-8-104 leading the Thunder 9-11-65. Kudos to you for watching in on Thunder Vision this afternoon. Over 2,000 viewers we've had throughout the afternoon, of course. A huge contingency at Cazaley's in Palmerston as well. And I believe we've even got an Olympic gold medal watching in. Mel Schlanger has tweeted through that she's watching the Lions from the couch. She's, of course, a Lions ambassador as well. So thanks for joining us, Mel, and everybody else who's watching in on Thunder Vision this afternoon. In what's been a pretty good game of football between the Lions and the Thunder, we're going to get the last quarter underway with the Lions up by 39 points, Ronnie McDonald.
Well, let's hope the Thunder can really show some heart and some spirit here. Up they go, Longer wins the tap. Down to Clay Beams, down to Eamon Buchanan. We've called that countless times through the third quarter. They go forward again. Ball bounces there before Ruska and Fox. Fox just palms it for the boundary line. That's clever again by the young fella. For a young man, he's done some good things.
A few men running around out here. That's their last quarter of football as well. We think this might be Shannon Ruska's last quarter of football, and also we know it's Eamon Buchanan's last quarter of football.
So it's Tyrrell against Longer. Longer gets front position. He's got stronger and longer as the game's gone on. Down towards the wing. This is Doherty, who started the game so well. The young man who really set the standard in defence when they were really under pressure, the Brisbane Lions, in that first corner. It's hard to believe that they trailed 5-2 to 2-2 at quarter time, given the way that they've played the last two quarters. The throw in again. It's Tyrrell, fights there with Longer. Umpire lets them go. It's Dignan who's got better as the game's worn on. Farrow with the big fly. Good ball from behind by Yeo. Heenan, he's flashed in and out of it. Doherty again. This is Scott Clark, who's been terrifically impressive. Again, another young top-up player. He comes wide looking for Dave Cummins. Another Western Magpie. He's got Eamon Buchanan. His stats would start certainly starting to be move up towards the region of 30 to 35 possessions. Has a bounce. He's got no one on. He's run himself into problem here.
He's given three don't argues there. He gave one to Ozzie Wanamiri and one to Matty Rozier as well.
Heenan, that's a spearing kick in towards half forward. Lockwood couldn't get a handle on it. Niall McKeever has not got a lot of possessions today, but some of his effective spoiling and tackling and chasing has been absolutely first class.
100% agree.
As he did again. This is Karnesis. He'll snap around his body. Didn't get a good purchase on the football on that one. Tapp, as he's done all day, his sport. He's worked particularly hard. He's been hardly beaten in a contest. Rosier, oh, he's overrun it. Gee, he's looking tired and sore, Matty Rosier. He's looking very tired. Williams again, who's really worked his way high up into the best player list for the Thunder on what he's done. And he's playing with more spirit than most as McKeever wheels around onto that left foot. Just clears Dignan. Beams, he is a Rolls Royce. That was best picked up off the boot laces. Goes long. Oh, Cornelius overran it. This is Rioli. He's certainly been far from the Thunder's worst as well. Oh, but pops it up for Lawler. So Buchanan just eases in to take the mark over the top. He's got Beams running for him. Just chips it up for him. That's the way it goes. And those two have certainly left a firm imprint on this game of football. Reminds us a bit of the 2000 a one grand final win. Ben Robbins, who'd played some senior football for the Brisbane Lions, went and played a little bit more with North Melbourne after that, had 44 possessions and really dominated the midfield as the Brisbane Lions reserves overcame a 20-point halftime deficit to beat Southport. And certainly Buchanan and Beams are following in the footsteps very much of Benny Robbins, who was so good that day.
They are indeed, as Clay Beams lining up for his third goal of the afternoon. His first two have been absolutely brilliant. This one from the set shot follows in the footsteps of the other two. That is an absolutely fantastic kick by Beams. He's kicked goals in the second, third, and now the final quarter as the Lions extend their lead once again. They go to 17-8, 110. The Thunder are 9-11-65. It's academic from here on in, Ronnie McDonald. We said we've done the non-politically correct thing at three-quarter time by riding the Thunder off, but it's the right call.
Yeah, well, look, that was always the reality of the situation, and we talked about it a little bit there on the stroke of three-quarter time, but that that early period of the third term when the Thunder kicked behinds instead of goals, you look at the scoreboard now and it's 25 scoring shots apiece. It's 25 scoring shots to 20. Maths wasn't always the strong point at school, but they had their opportunities in that third quarter and didn't take them, and the Lions have made them pay, and Beam certainly exemplifies that. His kicking of goals just been absolutely first class, as has his field kicking, and it'd take, I think, a lot from here for him to lose any, to not be considered the absolute...
To not take home two medals.
Two medals, yes. Yes, the one being a premiership and one being the Joe Grant.
Correct.
Now, Julian Lockwood, he's tried hard today. Things haven't really worked for him, but he's really certainly tried hard.
And he's got the football because Kenrick Terrell steamrolled his way through the middle of the ground from the ruck contest and willed the ball forward with everything he had.
And that's the way Tyrrell plays his football. He is, he's been a terrific state ruckman for WA, for Queensland and the Northern Territory on a couple of occasions. Lockwood. Oh, that's going to go across on the breeze as well. He'll sneak in for a minor score.
It's been the story of his, not so much day, but the last fortnight. I didn't think he was all that flash in the preliminary final last week, Julian Lockwood. And he's had a dirty one today as well.
9-12. They trail the Lions, who are 17-8. And Karnesis, who has just knocked up getting possessions. But that one was a little lazy. So Jed Anderson, who's been really quiet for a player of his class, he's only a young man, but he's a terrific player, just hasn't been able to find the footy today. It's that man McKeever again. Goes by hand towards Yo. Sorry, that's Crisp. Crisp on the left foot goes long, sits it up for Lyle. Provides a good contest.
There's Rowe. We go from talking about Yo to talking about Rowe. He finds Islet in the middle of the ground. It's a kick out on the forward flank. This is Lockie Argus. Can go deep inside forward 50. Ewing's one out. Almost takes a great mark to spoof Ewing. Good work in the end by Clark, who sees the ball over the boundary line for the Lions and over for a boundary throw in.
Yeah, Jason Rowe's been fantastic. We've said that all game. I just don't know if the judges, and don't know who's adjudicating on it today. Normally you're the media collectively are asked to give votes, but I don't know who's doing it today. But
you couldn't put him above Beams or Buchanan,
yes,
I would think.
Yes, it's going to be difficult for a guy in a team that's losing by this much to be given the medal. Only one Joe Grant medal in history has gone to a player from the losing team. That was Jacob Goff in 2008 when the Morningside Panthers were beaten by Southport in a clinking grand final down at Carrara, and Goff was part of the losing team but played a mountainous game. As Cameron Islet, he's going to wheel around onto the non-preferred left foot, but he can't find the major opening either, and that's going to dribble over the boundary line for a throw-in.
At the rub of the green, last week he kicked those through the goals. This week, didn't even find the scoreboard. So the ball thrown in next to the point post, deep in the Thunder forward line. Good work at the back of the pack by Longer to get the tap down for the Lions. Besieged straight away, though, with the Lions on ballers. And we're going to have a secondary ball up. Seems to be all academic from here on in. We'll look to see a couple of long-running goals to just absolutely ignite party time from here on in for the Lions, Ronnie McDonald. Or will the Thunder put some credibility back on the scoreboard for themselves?
Well, they're certainly not going down without a fight, the Thunder. They've got plenty of numbers around the ball. They're all trying hard, but it's just not happening for them.
It's not. You can see that with the way that some of the kicks are going this quarter. It's interesting. The Lions have got a fairly good contingent on the bench at the moment. Dyson sitting on the bench. Amon Buchanan's on the bench. And Billy Longer, of course. There's restrictions on how many AFL-listed players the Lions can have on the ground at any one time. They can only have 14 on at any one time. So that's why there's a fairly star-studded contingency on the bench at the moment. Is this up and under kick by McEwen? Tried to drag it around. Couldn't do so, though. And it's through 4-1 behind. Territory are now 9 goals, 12-66. They've updated that straight away. In fact, they haven't. It's 9-13-67. Either way, the Lions are 17-8-110. It is, 9-13-67 to the Thunder. And it's, 7.5 minutes in this final quarter, Ronnie.
And they had the runners there on the wing, and that man Beams is going to win himself another free kick. Ewing's chopped the arms. It was a good effort by Ewing there to run him down because he was running into plenty of clear space there. Ewing saw it was on and charged up from half forward, but he's managed to chop the arms. So Clay Beams,
free kick.
Almost called him Dane Beams. Hasn't he been a revelation in the AFL this year? Who knows, could win himself a Brownlow medal. And this young man, his younger brother, is certainly a very, very good footballer in his own right. He's overshot Hawksley on that occasion. Oh, Tyrrell's caught holding the football, is he?
Yep.
Yes, it looks like it is. And it's going to be big Billy Longer.
Just on the ground.
Kick it long towards full forward. Tapp's got the front position on Lyle. Lyle gave him a nudge and Tapp was strong enough to take the mark. Several of the defenders would certainly feature prominently in the Thunder's best players today and Tapp would be one of them. It's Heenan. He hasn't stopped trying either. Looks downfield, found himself Anderson. Anderson's still showing plenty of runs. Shows this man, Jack Lawler. Unfortunate for Lawler. Oh, he's just come inside there under pressure and there was just a nest of Lions there. Bartlett was one of them. He's gone back with not a lot to kick to. Islet couldn't get his arm out to extend there. That was a bit of a strange one.
A nest of Lions. I wouldn't like that falling out of my tree.
As we get ourselves a throw in here near half forward. Longer's going to go up against Tyrrell. Tyrrell's ruck most of the second half. You can see the strength of the wind there as Beams just charges onto the football. Clark's running down for it, but Williams is going to be satisfied just to take the ball over the boundary line for another throw-in, almost on the 50-metre arc. We've got the Lions leading by 43 points. Almost in front of the crowd. It's gone a little bit quiet. You talked about that hush, Sean. I think everybody here realises that the game's over of a contest. It's all academic now. But Cameron Islett's not going to stop trying as he kicks the ball high there towards centre wing. Big fly there by Viancom. Doherty got up high too. This is Yeo. He's got himself a man running for him. That's Cummins. Cummins battles there in front of him and gives it back to Yeo. He's going to be hemmed in. Thunder are going to be bearing down there, Wanamiri, but the umpire's found a free kick. It's going to go to the Thunder for a throw, is it? And that was a bit silly.
Yes,
he's
is.
Going to get himself a free kick. 50-metre penalty is Matiagas, so should certainly nail this. He'll shoot from just outside the goal square.
I think Jesse Wallen was just a little bit confused as to which way the free kick was going that time. I don't think that he meant to give it back to the wrong man. It was just confusion.
Nonetheless, Matty Argus in his 100th QAFL NEAFL game will shoot. And again, that really has been typical of the Thunder's day. He's missed, so they move to 9-14. So they've kicked 4 goals, 12 since quarter time.
So the Lions to bring the ball back in. They go long inside the centre square in the longer direction. He's got Tyrrell against him. Tyrrell went up, couldn't take the mark. Lions with the numbers at the fall. Great tackling by Matty Argus though. Viancom, ball falls to him. Can go inside forward 50. Great mark. Beautiful courage shown that time by the Brisbane Lions. A little bit of a tete-a-tete on centre wing.
Argus and Weirdham were having a little bit of a jumper tug, but no harm done.
Cleared up pretty quickly once they realised the football was coming in the direction. Big Sam Michael just behaved drunkenly for him, and it goes over the boundary line, and we'll have another boundary throw in.
11 minutes into the final quarter of the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final. There's some trainers still attending to a player there
centre half forward or centre half back, just trying to make as one of the Lions players.
So the ball thrown back in. Good little handball over Vassal. He's been good in the last quarter. Got tackled. Yep. Right decision by the umpire. I was going to say got tackled and didn't make any attempt to get rid of it. And Amon Buchanan coming up for yet another possession, which would have to have a three in front of it. You'd think his possession count, Ronnie.
And it looks like Cheney Stiller, who is, looks like he's holding his ribs there. He's looking very, very sore. But
he's going to be holding a Premiership Cup very shortly, so he could do with some rest as the captain of the Brisbane Lions, as Lyle went up high and going to get a free kick for over the shoulder as well. Just a sloppy tackle by Cameron Islett in the end. It's going to be a free kick to Jordan Lyle.
It was actually a terrific attempt at a mark, and it almost could have been paid a mark. So
you're
right. He's got it. It's come either way.
So Lyle, standing 55 out. He's already kicked four goals today. You wouldn't think this would be outside his range, but he goes with the short option. Sun just gets in the eyes of the man he was kicking it to, in Jack Crisp, and the mark is taken by Jason Rowe.
Hasn't stopped trying all day, and he's been so effective, Rowe, although that one's popped it up. He's made Lockie Argus work hard, but he's beaten two of them. This is Vassal. He'll turn inside onto the left. That was always going to happen. He's got on Amiri running for him, but Wrigley just climbs over the top and punches it forward. It's landed with Crisp. He had the runner there for him in Michael. He needed the sunglasses, but it's popped up there for him. Crisp runs in to help, gets around onto the left foot looking for Carnesis. I didn't stick in the trusty left hand, but he's butted up with the tackle. That ball's not going to come out in a hurry. Umpire's going to have to ball it up. Inside the Thunder attacking zone. 17-8 plays 9-14. Approaching 13 minutes of the last quarter. Thunder have just kicked the one goal for the second half. Doesn't look like it's going to come quickly here either as the ball runs over the boundary line.
Shoney Stiller in front of us just had a little bit of work done. He looks all right. He's just up and walking it off at the moment.
Did I say Thunder forward line? I'm sorry, I meant the Lions forward line. Got some players looking very, very tired there. Scott Clark looked like he might be cramping up. As the ball comes there towards Conway. Oh, kicked out of fresh air there. Another fresh air shot there by Rowe. But more effectively, the run's come from Williams, hasn't his confidence grown as the game's gone on?
He's been given a big job, and you could see early on it kind of overawed him a little bit, but he got on top, and then once he started getting on top of Cornelius, you're right, he's really grown in confidence.
Farrer appreciated the space, gave it to Heenan, and Buff Ewing shows that tremendous judgment that he's renowned
That's
for.
That's their
takes
best passage of play since the first quarter of the NT Thunder.
And he's kicked their second goal of the second half, Darren Ewing, his fifth of the game. Tremendous effort in a team that's being well beaten. And they've got their 10th for the day, the Thunder. They moved to 10-14-74. The Lions reserves are 17-8-110. And there's 15 minutes more to play out. And all credit to the Thunder for still fighting hard for the football there.
And they're going to. You just sense that the pride of the Thunder says that they're going to fight this one out until the final siren's gone, even if they know now that this is the Brisbane Lions Premiership, but they're still going to keep trying. And as we said, coast-to-coast football that time. Jason Rowe starting off by throwing his body on the line, and just a beautiful passage of play by the Thunder.
And good hard running there by Damien Williams has really done a
terrible
work for them.
Yeah, he has been fantastic.
But that was Eamon Buchanan who's won the ball. Now, is that a contested mark? Jason Rowe has just marked it superbly
against
Sean Tapp.
No, we'll just give him the mark for that one, Rowe. He's had enough stats as the day goes on, but the Thunder have just got a couple of players around the football at the moment trying to work it out of some congestion. Doherty's got it for the Lions.
Dignan,
he's going to be held up.
Dignan very unlucky not to get a free kick there for a trip.
I agree.
He was the man playing the football.
Bodies flying all over the place. The ball's bounced. Longer. Comes in. In fact, the Lions had a couple of big men in the contest that time. Michael, it was, that ended up getting the tap. Anderson, little up and under, towards half forward. Good mark by the Lions once again.
And it looks like
Dyson, is it?
Looks like Buchanan's taken a cork to the buttock there, getting up very gingerly.
Never fun.
But he's moving okay now.
It's Josh Dyson. Goes in board to Carnesis. Could get the football back here, Dyson, because he's run into position and no one's really manning him. So Carnesis instead goes back. Now Dyson is going to get the ball back. Ran into a couple of defenders, but had the wherewithal to get around them. Kicks the football up the line. Rowe put his body on the line again, but it's only as far as Carnesis, who can take a running bounce. Now can deliver towards the middle of the ground. Fox had the football bumped away from him. Carnesis butters up. Buchanan had to deliver, did nicely. Had the defenders bearing down on him. Chance for the Thunder, who just steal it now. Anderson's got some clear space to run into if he wants it. Kick's not great. Mark taken by Billy Longa.
Great pressure by the Thunder there for a team that's trailing by seven goals. The effort there and the seconds and thirds efforts was just terrific.
So the Lions, ball on the far wing at the moment. They find their target. Looks like a big Clark, I think it might be.
Just been so efficient with their forward 50 entries, the Lions.
They have indeed, and they get another one. Good work back of the pack. Lyle almost had the forward ball. Now quick kick around the corner by Callum Bartlett, and he gets his name in the paper as well for his first goal of the day. The Lions get their second goal for the quarter. They go to 18-8-1-16. The Thunder, it's 10-14-74. 17 minutes just about to approach here in the final quarter, and we're not too far away from seeing some jubilation on the faces of these Lions boys. I reckon the next goal that you'll see, we might see a bit of a celebration, Ronnie.
Yeah, it was a well-timed bump there by Lyle. He just nudged Lockwood right under the football and the spillage over the back. They had the crummers there, and Bartlett's very, very good at that, and he was never going to miss from close range. So, eight goals to the good. The Brisbane Lions reserves won the premiership in 2001, the same year that they won their first ever AFL premiership. Great double for a very, very proud club. And here's the man we expect to win the Joe Grant medal. He's just a Rolls Royce at this level, is Clay Beams.
Yeah, if the name Beams or Buchanan isn't read out when that Joe Grant medal's selected, I'm going to drug test.
Lyle, again, has been particularly effective. He's kicked four, and I reckon he's given that to way three or four, Jordan Lyle. That's terrific work to Callum Bartlett. He gets his second goal in a minute, and that scoreboard keeps on ticking over. It's their 19th. They're 19-8, the Lions. The NT Thunder are 10-14. And we've still got another 10 minutes to go in the NEAFL Northern Conference Grand Final. The Thunder are being brave, but the Lions, like we spoke about, their efficiency moving forward, they're just too sharp. They're surgeon-like when they move forward.
As I was saying, if the name Clay Beams or Eamon Buchanan isn't read out as the Joe Grant medalist, I'll drug test the selectors. They've been that good. But Jordan Lyle, I tell you what, he has done some fantastic work today. He, as you mentioned, he's kicked four goals. He's probably set up another four or five as well. And the forward pressure that he's put on as well to keep the football in the zone has been just absolutely fantastic.
And Lockwood's had to go back from centre-half forward onto Lyle because of the problems that he's been posing, as Jack Lawler has a run on the ball and wins the ball forward for the Thunder. Dunn's going to run onto it. But Yeo has just, he's a very good young player, Yeo. He's gone out of bounds there, but he's done a very, very solid job for the Lions today too. If you look all over the park, they've been very solid. They've had very, very few losers in any positions, the Brisbane Lions reserves.
And we like calling Yeo as much as we can as well. It's a really good name for a commentator to call. So the ball thrown back in. It's going to be a free kick out of the stoppages there. It's going the way of the Thunder. Vinkum gives it to Islett. Islett kicks inside forward 50. Ewing on the lead. Takes a nice slips catch as well down low. Really good. Cameron Islett threaded the needle with that kick beautifully. And Ewing took the mark deep down. He's going to kick this one from probably 50 metres out. The angle's not going to suit him. But he's kicked five goals already today, and if anyone on the Thunder side can make this happen, it's Ewing, as he goes with the left foot, tried to have a crack at it. But as we said, the angle would not suit him at all, and it's gone out of bounds on the full.
Yeah, tried to overkick it, and as often happens when you try to overkick it, you kick it shorter than where it needs to be.
He saw Aaron Cornelius put one into the Brisbane River before and thought, I might do the same thing. So the Lions bring it in, find Doherty. Sam Doherty hasn't really got much movement for the next kick, so he's probably going to have to either switch or go straight up the line. The line's where he's going to go. It's going to be the boundary line that he's going to find. In fact, it's going to go into the Northern Territory coach's box and into the hands of Kevin Vickham, who's going to take the free kick. Gives it to Duncan. Haven't heard that name much today. So Ash Duncan. It's the little kick. Finds his target. Dunn. Another that we haven't called all that often. Another short chip kick. Nice mark taken in the end by Williams.
And the Lions have not dropped their work rate still. They have got every man in their team in the defensive part of the ground.
You can see that with the Thunder having to chip the ball. Rowe finds Rosier. Rosier's man on the mark standing probably 55 out. It's Cornelius. Inside forward 50. Uncontested mark taken in the end by big Niall McKeever. Switches play, finds Hawksley. Hawksley on the far wing.
makes the kick stick. The Lions, as they've done all day, streaming forward. Clark was the target. Couldn't take the mark, though, and the ball goes off hands and through for a boundary throw. And it was interesting to see Clay Beams stream down the ground with one hand in the air that time. Ben Rioli wearing him like a glove all the way down.
So the boundary line throw in, that's Lockwood. He wins it down. This is Stiller, going to kept himself to a premiership. This is Lyle, who he's got busier and busier in this half. But here's Jason Rowe. If he is certainly clearly the Thunder's best player. Takes two bounces and kicks it long towards the goal square. Farrah's in best position to mark. That's spectacular stuff. Oh, umpire calls play on. Crowd didn't like that one. There was clearly a mark to Will Farrah. Fortunately, it's all academic. Dyson knocks up another touch for this big, big second half. Gives it to Michael. Michael, who was just so important in the Lions' second semi-final win in Darwin. And that game certainly set up this premiership win for the Brisbane Lions reserves. They were only the second team ever to win in Darwin in that second semi. It meant the Thunder had to travel last week, and it's a big, big ask to have to travel to Brisbane twice at finals time. This is done. Goes forward. It's a scrappy old looking kick, and this is Doherty, who is, other than the second quarter, he's been terrific across most of the game, the youngster. It's crisp. Takes the ball from Dyson. Dyson's second half's been mammoth. This is Bartlett. He's going to cramp up.
His second half's been pretty good too.
Under that trusty left foot. Falls a bit short, but Hawksley, he's another one who's been particularly good. They've created space out on that far side, and it's Niall McKeever running down. Really liked his game. Great defender's game.
Yeah, it's been fantastic. And it's one for those unsung defenders all over the country that they look at the stat sheet and see they've only had five or six kicks, and it may not necessarily on the stat sheet look like they've had a great game, but Niall McKeever's in my best three or four on the ground.
And you talked about the run of Clay Beams. He zigzagged all across the forward line. He covered about 400 metres there, wound up on the lead on the other side of the ground, and he's found himself another shot at goal.
Kick three already, Clay Beams. One in each of the second, third and fourth quarters. So Beams shoots from just inside the 50. Beautiful long kick. Goal umpire didn't move. Fourth for the day for Clay Beams. You'd think he's on the way to the Joe Grant medal for the best player on the ground. And the Lions, they move to 20 goals, 8, 128. The Thunder are 10, 14, 74. It's out beyond 10 goals, this margin now for the Lions. 23 and a half minutes gone, final quarter. Premiership Cup heading to the Hyundai Centre.
That was a huge kick by Clay Beams too. He kicked it from just inside the 50 metre line. It's gone over the goals post high and well back into the crowd there. They must have travelled all of 65 metres and never looked like missing.
Never looked like missing. You're dead right there, Ronnie. It was straight as a die all the way through. It's the Thunder. Stream it forward. Tyrrell high up inside forward 50. Lines get the numbers back. Do good defending. Overrunning the football that time, though, was Stiller. Opens the door for the Thunder. Lockie Argus. Stiller does beautifully with the tackle, though. Holds up Argus. And umpire's going to call for the ball, is he? No, he's giving the free kick to Stiller, and quite rightly so as well. So Shaney Stiller. It's about 15 minutes away from holding a Premiership Cup aloft. The captain of the Brisbane Lions. Throughout the second half of this season, it must be said, it was James Hawksley earlier in the season. But upon his promotion into the senior side, the captaincy was given to Stiller. Tyrrell, handball to Wylett, who ran himself into trouble and has been pinged for holding the ball.
Yeah, gee, he didn't have a lot to go there. He was sold into big trouble there by Kenrick Tyrrell.
Huge trouble. I think Tyrrell just wanted to get rid of it as crisp. Up the line to Clark. Clark got the shepherd that time, but Lyle, who's the next option because he's still got 20 metres in the clear. Lyle, he can load this one up if he likes. He's 50 metres out, can have a flying shot instead, puts it to the square. Disciplined play by Lyle. Buchanan couldn't mark. Thunder defenders get mugged. Fox tried to take it. Free kick to the Thunder. Free kick to the NT Thunder defenders. Damian Williams, it is. He has just not stopped trying all day. In fact, it's Duncan. Duncan kicks the ball over. Now the Thunder can run out of the back line. Great to see them still going as Argus takes the mark. Glen Argus around the corner. Finds Rowe, who snuck up towards half forward. Jason Rowe kicks the ball on. Heenan's his target. Had to do the work at the back of the pack. Lions get the numbers going forward. Well done. Just trying to find their target. Now the Lions sharing it, using that opposite side of the ground nicely. Put under kick. It's going to bounce. Carnesis needs to run onto it. Does nicely in the end against two. Drops it at the crucial moment, though. Umpire could have paid holding the ball. Didn't. It's in the centre of Leishon Park. Carnesis goes in and tries to win it. Gets claimed in the tackle. It's going to be picked, going to be the umpire's ball. And he's going to bounce it in the true centre of Leishon Park, Yeronga. As we've crossed over the 26-minute mark in this final quarter, it is a 54-point lead to the Lions.
Now you look at those players involved in that play, Clay Beams and Patrick Carnesis, and you think, you wonder whether they will be the Des Headlands and the Craig Boltons who go on to be very, very good players at AFL level. Sean Tapp, he has not stopped trying, been one of the better players in defence. Heenan has tried hard too, but he's lost his feet. Plenty of room to move in though there, and he just waltzes around longer. Nice looking pass in there for Tyrrell, pushed out of the way there by Sam Michael. Good mark by the young fella, originally from Redlands, trying to make his mark in the AFL world, and he's fined that man Dyson again. He's got runners everywhere. Elects to go there towards Jesse Wallen. Played some terrific games with Morningside during this season, Wallen, but was eligible for the Lions reserves. He elects to go long there looking for Lyle, opposed to Lockwood. Lyle takes front position, can't get a handle on it, and Lockie Argus is content to run the ball over the boundary line for a throw-in. 27 minutes into the final quarter. It won't be long now, the final siren. It's a 9-goal lead to the Brisbane Lions reserves. They've done it very, very comfortably since quarter time. Boundary throw-in. Longo up against Vincom. Hawksley over the top. If this bounces for Stiller, he's going to have a shot at goal on the right foot. No, he centres it looking for Lyle.
Free kick.
Umpire says Lockie Argus, that was way too late. And so Jordan Lyle's going to line up for goal number 5.
You've got to appreciate the discipline of the Lions players. 54-point lead late in the last quarter, and Shaney Stiller is still centering the ball rather than trying to blaze away and have the glory goal in the end of a grand final. Really good discipline by the Lions.
So it's Jordan Lyle, first-year Brisbane Lions player. Played some impressive senior footy late in the year. Should have no problems from there. He'll give a bloke a rap. He's kicked it off the inside of the foot, but it doesn't matter. It's a goal. Number 5. To the big man, the 21st for the Brisbane Lions. They've kicked 21 goals, 8, which is terrific kicking on any day of the season. And it's the sort of day that you really want to kick straight on grand final day, and that's what they've done. It's probably reflective of the way they've taken the ball forward too, Sean. They've managed to generate a lot of shots from within 15 to 20 metres of goal, and that certainly helps.
Yep, the only one, apart from really someone like Clay Beams, who has just hit the ball beautifully from 45 and 50 metres out every time, they've done that. They've played to the strengths of their forwards and tried to get them isolated 20 to 20, no more than really 30 metres out from goal. So the ball back in the centre of the ground. Ruckman negate each other. Nice work, Anderson. Just can't quite pick up the football at the moment. A hot footy it was. Flying in that time, Clark was over the football. And in the end, it's going to be another ball up. So the Lions, it's a resignation on the bench now. The coaching staff are down at ground level. They know that the premiership's their way. The congratulations have started. Longer got the tap. Vassal, high up and under inside the forward line. Uncontested mark taken. Some work. Buff Ewing just got held out of that one. But it didn't matter because it allowed Doherty to take the uncontested mark. So Doherty kicks up towards the halfback line. There it is. The Brisbane Lions are the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference Premiers. They win it convincingly in the end, 21-8-134 to the Northern Territory Thunder, 10-14-74, an even 10-goal victory. Congratulations to the Brisbane Lions. Goal kickers 5 to Jordan Lyle, 4 to Clay Beams, 2 each to Hawksley, Bartlett and Aaron Cornelius and Jack Fox. Singles to Dyson, Stiller, Buchanan and Jack Crisp. For the Thunder, 5 goals to Buff Ewing, played a lone hand up forward. 2 to Willie Farrer, 2 to Austin Wanamiri, and 1 to Patrick Heenan. In what was a good first quarter by the Thunder, but they couldn't keep it going after that. The Lions kicking 19 goals to 5 for the remainder of the game. The Brisbane Lions, well and truly deserved of the title of Premiers for season 2012, finished the home and away season in second place. Convincing winners against Southport in the qualifying final. They're only the second team ever to defeat the Northern Territory Thunder in Darwin in the second semi-final, and they've run away with this grand final win, 21-8-134, as we can see, defeating the Thunder 10-14-74. Ronnie McDonald, the last word, the Joe Grant medal about to be rewarded. Clay Beams, Eamon Buchanan, you'd think it'd have to be Beams.
Oh, look, I think Beams was the one. He was the one who won particularly particular amount of the hard balls through the middle. His clearances were great, and his poise with the ball in his hands was terrific. Oh, look, I'd give a vote to Jason Rowe too. I thought his level of effort and effectiveness from go to woe was outstanding. And if the Thunder were a little bit closer, you might consider that he'd be a chance for it. But the size of the victory, they've kicked 11 goals to 2 after half time. It was only 13 points at half time, but they've kicked 11 goals to 2 for a most emphatic victory. Look, congratulations to Nathan Clark, the former Brisbane Lions player. He played 6 games for the Lions through 2000, 2001, 2002. He was a very classy wingman. He was a classy bloke, and he's done a very, very good job with this team. As we said, they finished last season, the Brisbane Lions reserves. They lost a lot of close games of football. They were by no means an easy beat. Never lost his cool. Fostered a terrific relationship with the Western Magpies, as we said. So this is just reward for Nathan Clark's effort and for the time and the effort that he's put in. His assistants, Paul Grintel and Matthew Smith and the like. So there's no doubt that they've got some very good cattle at their disposal, but by the same token, they put a lot of time and effort into this. Look, the Thunder weren't disgraced. They certainly tried hard. You couldn't question their effort, their endeavour. But those shots at goal in the third quarter in particularly really hurt.
They did indeed. That's it from us on Thunder Vision. It's been a fantastic grand final, a fantastic conclusion to the Northern Conference season for the NEAFL this year. The Brisbane Lions have still got another game left in them, would you believe? They'll play the cross-conference grand final next weekend in New South Wales against the winner of the Sydney Swans and Queanbeyan grand final in the Eastern Conference. But for Ron McDonald, I'm Sean Kelly. It's been a pleasure joining you this afternoon and bringing the 2012 NEAFL Northern Conference grand final to you. So long from Thunder Vision for season 2012. Thunder Vision will be back in 2013. Keep an eye on it. And that'll do it.